अर्हतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स नमो तस्स भगवतो अर्हतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स नमो तस्स भगवतो अर्हतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स बुद्धं शरणं गच्छामि धम्मं शरणं गच्छामि संघं शरणं गच्छामि। So, good afternoon and welcome to this class. We have decided to take a review of what we did in the 10 classes. So, I think that review also will take a few classes. So, करते हैं धीरे धीरे करते हैं ये अब जब आई वर्कशॉप करता हूँ आईआईटी में तो दिस इज द पिक्चर विच आई यूज एज ए बेसिक आइकॉन दैट ऑल द वट एवर यू हैव डन मेडिटेशन और स्टडी और टीचिंग ऑल दिस इज मेंट सो दैट वी कैन फेस अवर सेल्स सो दैट वी कैन नो अवर सेल्स इन द रियल सेंस ऑफ द टर्म नॉट जस्ट सुपरफिशियली बट इन द रियली वट एग्जैक्टली वी आर what exactly is going on, because that is where the freedom lies. So the very first thing which we discussed in our classes was the Four Noble Truths. So you'll have to explain to me. Now I'm going to ask you the questions in the same way that I was asked in IIT. Of course, aap logon ne utne sawal puchte nahi the. Wahan bahut sawal puche jaate hain, to usi intensity se sawal puche jayenge, to aapko jawab dena hai. So, who will state first? Very simple statement of the four truths. What are the statements? You have to take the mic. You are the controller. Yes.
First is that there is something.
Give it a few seconds.
The first noble truth is that there is suffering.
Okay. So it's called Dukkham Ariya Satcham. Okay, there is a noble truth of suffering. So we'll let first put it down, then we'll discuss. Or second, kya hai? Bol do, sare bol do. Statement to asaan hona chahiye.
There is a cause for the suffering.
There is a cause of suffering. You know, it's a typical medical paradigm. Okay? There's some cause of dukkha. So we say in Pali, Dukkha Samudayo Ariya Satcham. Then third noble truth,
cessation of suffering.
There is a nirodha. The word used there in Pali, cessation of nirodha of dukkha, non-arising. Actually, nirodha means non-arising dukkha. Cessation se aisa lagta hai jaise pehle suffering arise hui, fir khatam hui. Actually, implies non-arising. Okay. And the fourth is
there is a path
which leads to dukkha.
Nirodha.
So good, so we know the statements. So we have put here Dukkha Ariya Satcham. So firstly, what exactly do we mean by Dukkha? Who will explain? Dukkha Shabd ka, what is the implication of the word Dukkha? What is the scope which includes?
Pain is referred to as dukkha, but in Buddhist terminology is more to do with psychological pain rather than just the pain, suffering. It is using suffering as a tool not eliminate, but for dukkha nirodha.
So to understand these things, I think it is good that we go a next step, which is we put down these definitions. Okay, जो हमने डिस्कस किया था क्लास में, वी हैड डिफाइंड व्हाट इज दुख, वी हैड डिफाइंड व्हाट इज समुदाय, एंड ऑल ऑफ ऑल दीज टर्म्स आर डिफाइंड प्रॉपरली, है ना. सो एटलीस्ट फर्स्ट स्लाइड वी हैव बीन एबल टू रिस्पॉन्ड, सो वी कैन बी अ लिटिल हैप्पी. ओके, देन वी कम टू द डिटेल्ड एक्सपोजिशन. So you tell us, what exactly does each one of them in detail mean? So let us take the first one. What does it mean? What is the statement?
There is dukkha. Sir, dukkha has a scope as per the Buddha's teaching, like everything from birth till death.
So uski agar aapko yaad ho,
yes sir,
statement of the
jati dukkha jarapi dukkha,
kyunki hum log chant karte rehte hai na roz.
Sir, sir.
तो याद होना चाहिए
सब, प्रिय का बिछड़ना दुख, अप्रिय
ऐसा करते हैं चैंटिंग बुक ला, आई थिंक इट विल बी गुड.
सर रट्टा नहीं है.
हां नहीं ठीक है, आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड. सो वी विल हैव अ ओपन बुक टेस्ट. ओके, विल हैव ओपन बुक टेस्ट.
आई रोट इट
डाउन सर. ओपन बुक टेस्ट.
आई चीट सर. जाति जाति पि जरापि व्याधि मरणमपि अपियेहि संपयोगो दुःखो, अपियेहि एंड देन पियेहि संपयोगो दुखो, यम्पि चम न लभति इज दुख. इन शॉर्ट द फाइव एग्रीगेट्स आर दुख.
सो लेट अस डू अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ रिवीजन, उसकी चैंटिंग करते हैं ताकि वो क्लियर भी हो जाए, और जो हम रोज चैंट करते हैं उसका फायदा हो ना हमको, तो फिर उसको एक एक शब्द को समझने की कोशिश करते हैं. आप मैंने सारे एक एक वर्ड को समझाया था, तो यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन टू मी दैट ईच एंड एवरी वर्ड. Firstly, why is it called the noble truth of suffering? Normally, suffering तो बड़ा परेशान करने वाली चीज है ना, तो उसमें noble क्यों कहते हैं? Why do you put use ariya satcham? We discussed this also.
It's a universal truth which helps you break the cycle of
Anybody else can put more succinctly? I'm not saying it's right or wrong, but we can put it more succinctly.
One thing, like, whosoever understand all these four truths will become a noble person.
Yeah, so you can say, so he becomes an arya. So we can say, especially a better translation would be ennobling truth, a truth by which one becomes a noble person. By understanding that, you know. So, chant karte hain chaliye. What is the first noble truth? Let's chant that. Who will lead? It is in the piche. वो जो सुत्ता है ना, पूरा complete सुत्ता, धम्मचक्र प्रवर्तन सुत्ता, end में आखिरी जहाँ प्रोमिनेंट सूत्र है ना, उसमें तीन सूत्र दिए हुए हैं, धम्म चक्र भी दिए हुए. पेज नंबर देख लीजिए. नहीं नहीं, नाइन नहीं होगा, वो एंड में है, आखिर में, सौ के करीब होगा, अस्सी के करीब पेज. पूरा सूत्र दिया हुआ ना, शुरू में तो एक्सट्रैक्ट दिए हुए हैं. एक मुझे दे दो यार अर्पण, मैं खोल देता हूँ. हाँ, ऑफ कोर्स हिंदी में दिया हुआ ना, ऑफ कोर्स. कमल जी ने इतनी मेहनत की है भाई. पेज 96, हिंदी वाली बुकलेट है 96 पेज. हिंदी वाला करने दो यार सबको, हमारे पास है ना हिंदी का.
हिंदी में 55 तक ही है.
नहीं, वो पुरानी पुराना ले लिया, वो आपने पुराना वर्शन ले लिया ना.
फोर्थ एडिशन.
हाँ, सिक्स्थ एडिशन है ना हमारा, नहीं है तो फिर यही तो होगा. हाँ, चलो इससे देख लो.
हाँ,
सिक्स्थ एडिशन में 96 पेज है, और इसमें इंग्लिश वाले में 110. The definitions, we'll just focus on the definitions. 112 page number. ये book है English वाली, इसमें 112 number page. और अगर छठा edition ये है, तो उसमें 96 page. करिए, चलिए. Let us chant it and see first one, first noble truth, and then understand. जो English वाली छोटी booklet है, 112 number page है. 112 पेज नंबर है उसमें जो ये हमारी किताब है जो नाना चाँद की 112 पेज तो क्या डेफिनेशन क्या दी गई है भगवान ने दुख की बिकॉज इट्स बेसिकली अ डेफिनेशन दुख हरी ऐसे Idam kho pana bhikkhave dukkham ariya satcham. So then read it out, one of you.
Third paragraph.
Jati pi dukkha, jara pi dukkha, mannam pi dukkham, soka parideva dukkha tomas payasa.
Pi dukkha.
Pi dukkha. Appiye hi sampayogo dukkho, piye hi vipayogo dukkho, yam pi cham dadavati kam pi dukkham.
Okay, so let's concentrate on this and try to understand it. तो जाति भी दुखा जो ये कहा जा रहा है हम तो बर्थडे सेलिब्रेट करते हैं आप कह रहे हैं जाति भी दुखा कौन समझाएगा इसको बताइए एंड दिस इज द क्वेश्चन आई यूज टू फेस सो इट्स अ टाइम दैट समबडी आंसर देम फॉर मी ऑल्सो बिकॉज स्टूडेंट्स कैन बी pretty tough कि हम तो रोज हर साल अपना बर्थडे मनाते हैं आप कह रहे हैं जाति भी दुखा ये क्या बात हुई
The biggest cause of death is birth and death is one of the huge death is one of the huge suffering and rather only it is the basically alive people we as alive people suffer from suffering and all we are they can't say
good one huh? so better be dead so better be dead
okay
bataiye bataiye jab tak aap unko left right front side sab taraf se nahi samjhenge na tab tak wo sink nahi karega Why do you say? Why does he say जाति पे दुखा?
कि जो समय पीछे बीत गया, चला गया, और जो use नहीं किया एक purpose के लिए.
Yes. When somebody asked Ajanta, I think, why do we suffer? The answer was because you are born. So. Conventionally, it is okay. You want to celebrate birth. There is no problem in that. So we should not mix up the two things as a convention and from the point of view of ultimate truth.
Right.
So if we understand this issue of jati pi dukkha, अगर इसको समझेंगे, तभी तो हम जरा जन्म मृत्यु के चरण चक्कर से बाहर निकलने की सोचेंगे वरना क्यों सोचेंगे? Why should anybody think of transcending the cycle of birth and death? अपना ठीक से arrange कर लो जीवन को और Be happy. Why bother? So this is a very crucial thing which we need to internalize.
So can we say even the process of birth is painful?
No,
in itself
is a, part,
is a suffering.
The process is painful. Of course, that is true. That also
maybe
is
we
true.
Don't remember, but
that also is true. But there is a very fundamental issue involved in that statement. Jati pi dukkha. और जरा भी दुखा तो शायद सबको समझ आ ही जाता उसमें तो दिक्कत नहीं है.
Sir, ignorance also? Can we say the birth is because of ignorance? Is that?
We can shift it to so many reasons eventually. That we'll do. अभी तो हम इतना ही कोशिश कर रहे हैं समझने की. Just this statement. Of course, it's not. It's right. We are born because of ignorance. अभी तो statement इतना समझने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. And मैं सवाल पूछ रहा हूँ आप जवाब दे रहे हैं. You cannot ask me now. तो जाति भी दुखा मैंने पूछा था. अब जरा भी दुखा तो शायद सबको हमको समझ में आता है मरणम अपनी दुखम भी शायद समझ ही आता है और फिर अगला क्या है, शोक परिदेव दुख दो तो मनस से उपाया सापि दुख। तो चीखना चिल्लाना रोना धोना ये तो समझ में आता है। फिर क्या है, अप्रिय ही संपयोग, ये भी मुझे समझ में आता है भाई, प्रिय का संयोग हो जाता है तो दुख होता है। फिर आया प्रिय ही विपयोग हो दुख, जो प्रिय है उससे वियोग होगा तो अप्रिय से संयोग होगा और विप्रिय से वियोग होगा तो दुख होगा, ये भी समझ में आता है। यम पी इच्छा मना लभती तम पी दुख, जो इच्छा मां करते हैं नहीं मिलता तो दुख होता है, ये भी समझ में आ सकती है बात। अब कहा संक्षिप्त न पंच उपादान खंदा दुख, ये क्या है, संक्षेप में पांच उपादान खंद दुख है, इसका क्या मतलब है, क्या खंद है और क्या दुख है बताइए, क्या खंद है बताइए पहले, हाँ क्या क्या है, खंदों के नाम बताइए ना,
वेदना,
मैं उनकी फोटो बना देता हूँ यहाँ पे ये टिपिकल जैन मेथड ऑफ शोइंग फाइव खंदास,
नाम रूप वेदना संस्कार,
बी केयरफुल,
नो रूप नाम सर सीक्वेंस नहीं मान,
नहीं नहीं सीक्वेंस नहीं, बट नाम इज नॉट ए खंदा, नाम तो खंदा नहीं है ना,
रूप वेदना संस्कार
वेरी गुड,
विज्ञानम
संज्ञा, ठीक वेरी गुड। तो आप रूप बताइए क्या हुआ, एक एक करके सब बताइए, आप बताइए रूप क्या है, फिर अगला 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 सारे बता दीजिए। पांच में एक रूप है ना, पहला खंड इन्होंने जैसे बताया, तो रूप का क्या मतलब हुआ,
मटेरियल्स,
माइक दे दीजिए,
जो चीज हम देख सकते हैं जो फील कर सकते हैं, दैट इज समथिंग,
रूप खंड का क्या तात्पर्य है, रूप खंड कहते हैं
ऑब्जेक्ट एनीथिंग लाइक दैट,
रूप का क्या मतलब, हिंदी में रूप किसको कहते हैं, मैंने रूप देखा, क्या मतलब हिंदी में, क्या मतलब होता है रूप से,
कैट वन थिंग व्हिच कैन बी सेंस थ्रू आवर सेंस,
किसको कहते हैं तुम्हारा रूप बहुत सुंदर है, उसका क्या मतलब होता है, फॉर्म, एक्सटर्नल फॉर्म,
इट्स अ फॉर्म,
सो रूप मींस द फॉर्म, एक्सटर्नल फॉर्म, सो रूप का क्या, उसको एक खंड बताया गया, बेसिकली इन टर्म्स ऑफ माइंड मैटर डिवीजन इट विल बी द मैटर, ठीक है ना, आगे नेक्स्ट
द रूप और द नेक्स्ट वन,
नेक्स्ट इफ यू हैव टू ऐड समथिंग प्लीज एक्सप्लेन बेटर इफ यू कैन,
या रूप इज समथिंग which we can contact, which we can see, the bodily thing, material, right? And second is Vedna, it is pleasant, unpleasant, and also neutral, right?
Can you give examples of
that? Like when
so this is Roop, okay, let us take simple. Yeah, Roop, usko Roop kehte hain, jo shareer bhari bhari baitha hua hai yahan pe, usko Roop kaha. So Vedna kya matlab?
Like suppose I get an injury, maybe on my leg, which is a...
There is the injury.
Yeah, so that is unpleasant, right?
Injury bhi available hai.
That's unpleasant.
Huh?
That is unpleasant. unpleasant feeling, you can say. Bodily unpleasant feeling.
Hmm.
Suppose my father died, so that will be like mental unpleasant feeling.
Hmm. Okay.
Yeah, pleasant maybe like, suppose in terms of sensual thing, I ate a good food, so that is pleasant feeling. Maybe I have a like, maybe a absorption, a good meditation, so that will be pleasant feeling in a mental state, right?
Okay. Then, ये वेदना खंड हो गया, अगला खंड क्या है?
संस्कार, संकार,
traditionally
संन्या
बोला जाता
है, संन्या,
it doesn't matter of course, संन्या ही बता, चलो, संन्या क्या होता है?
So, whatever the wisdom or the knowledge we have, that can be sanya.
Make sure. Another chance. Nahi samajh mein aaya.
I don't know how to put it then.
Yes, Surbhi, can you help her?
Sir, sanya perception hota hai.
Hanji.
और जैसे हमारे हमारे आँखों के सामने कलर है, पहले कलर आता है तो देन वी फिगर आउट ओ ये धरसर है, धरसर आए हैं. सो देन द रिकॉग्निशन कम्स इन, द मेमोरी कम्स इन एंड
सो दैट इज द
दैट्स द परसेप्शन.
This is an important dimension of perception, but there are other dimensions also. We have impact of perception on feeling. Anyway, we can take care of that. Okay, next, what is the next kanda?
Yes, sir.
Sankhara.
So, from the feeling, sir, we can say that it pleasant feeling, or we're going to sit in a class now, we're going to... So, it could be that of course influences our perception. The feeling influences the perception in a very big way.
Anji. Feelings influence the perception. Perception influences the feelings. Feeling. How does perception influence the feeling? Give an example.
It's called chit bolte hain sir, or wo like rapidly.
Give simple day to day life example. Na?
How does perception? It could be that. Like right now sitting in the class, we are, it's a feeling that yes, there is, oh, so what is coming next? I don't know, sir. I'm just
okay,
kind
it's
of...
Okay, all right. Anji, Payal?
Something that you like...
How does perception influence feeling? Yes, please explain.
If your perception about it is...
I had given a strong example in class, if you remember, or you can give any example. Taki samajh mein aaye na.
If my perception says this is something that is going to benefit me, or something that is advantageous to me, when I come across that thing, that object, or that person, or that situation, I have a happy feeling. So my perception, or if something says this is danger and I come across something, my reaction or my
don't mix up things. You have to be precise. I understand what you're saying, but try to be precise, because then you will be able to practice properly. So if you see a tiger, suppose a tiger was to come into it, what would you see? What would happen? What is your perception of a tiger?
Danger, death, so blood, gore.
What kind of feelings you will get? Pleasant, unpleasant?
Unpleasant feeling. Yeah. So that's it. That is all.
And if it is a tiger which has been reared by you from childhood?
If it's my friend, then obviously I'm happy. So it's a pleasant feeling. Sensation.
Okay. You had given that example. Good. Okay, chaliye. Next, Sankhara.
So sankharas are basically reactions, our reaction to our perception, or it can be a mental reaction or a verbal or a physical reaction. So
what is a sankhara? Is it the physical reaction, or is it the verbal reaction, or is
any,
it the mental?
Any of the three. It can be even mentally, if I think of something.
Is sankhara a part of body, or is a sankhara a part of mind?
Starts with the mind, right?
So it has to be. What is uska translation kya karte hain sankhara ka angrezi mein?
Volition.
Mental.
Volitional
formation.
Volitional formation.
Okay. मन में जो उसका प्रतिक्रिया हुई, जो भी आया, देखा शेर, देखा प्रतिक्रिया क्या हुई, एक मित्र को देखा प्रतिक्रिया क्या हुई.
तो सर रिएक्ट करने से फिजिकल रिएक्शन विल नॉट बी संकारा,
ट्रांसलेट इनटू इट मे इवेंचुअली
लीड टू दैट, बट दैट विल आल्सो बी अ संकारा.
हर एक एक्शन के पीछे तो
इट विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द माइंड.
माइंड विल अराइज फर्स्ट, देन एक्शन विल
स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द माइंड, राइट?
सो इट इज द माइंड. सो व्हाट विल बी द डोमेन ऑफ संकारा? डोमेन क्या क्या चीजें संस्कार में आती है?
सो एवरीथिंग लाइक वट एवर वी आर थिंकिंग, वी आर सेइंग, वी आर डूइंग, कलेक्टिंग और हैबिट्स एंड हैबिट पैटर्न
इन टर्म्स ऑफ मेंटल फैक्टर्स,
क्रेविंग,
अवर्शन, लोभ, दोष, मोह, जेनरोसिटी, काइंडनेस, कंपैशन, देयर ऑल मेंटल फैक्टर्स व्हिच आर कमिंग बाय रिएक्शन टू द एक्सटर्नल इंपेटस.
Sir, accumulation of the past.
There are various nuances of sankhara. So this is the prominent one when we talk of here. In that sense, there are other nuances which we can put up in due course. Agla kya hai?
Agla vinyanam.
Anji, to gyan ka kya matlab?
Ab indriyon ka jo vigyan hai, usse matlab ye hai ki hamari jo senses hai, aur senses ki puri jankari.
Udaharan jaise?
Jaise, haan, matlab jo bhi hamari paanch senses hain, unke zariye, jaise main aankh se dekhta hoon.
तो विज्ञान क्या हुआ
तो मैं देखता हूँ और जो देखना है मेरा उसको कैसे मैं विजुलाइज करता हूँ मेंटली बिकॉज हाँ तो एक मतलब इंद्री ने काम किया देखने का बट उसके अल्टीमेटली जो माइंड है वो उसको उसको देखेगा कि किस मतलब उसको समझेगा कि जो देखा गया है वो उसमें What type of feelings are generated in my mind?
Vigyan kya hai? What is Vigyan? So we should be precise. Na? What does Vigyan mean? You are describing a process. I'm asking. Jaise inhone define kiya roop, vedana, sanya, sankhara. Ab keh rahe hain Vigyan kya hai? Kisko Vigyan kehte hain? precise karenge na. Jitna precise hoga understanding. उतना प्रिसीजन से हम साधना कर पाएंगे
व्हाट्स कमिंग इन माय माइंड इज दैट वी हैव दीस फाइव सेंस ऑर्गन्स सो लाइक द वन विद व्हिच इज रिलेटेड टू आई इज चक्षु विज्ञान
ये याद रखना चाहिए बार-बार बुद्धा कॉल्स सिक्स सेंस
यस वो
फाइव आर फिजिकल बिकॉज़ वी यूज्ड टू दैट दैट आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड बट वी शुड ट्राई टू रिमेंबर दैट
Right, sir. So, when it is seeing, it is Chakshu Vinyan arises. When the
what does it mean? Is, what does it mean, Chakshu Vinyan?
Consciousness is.
हाँ, but in practical terms, क्या मतलब उसका? जैसे वो कहते हैं ना, मैं देख रहा हूँ. तो मैं देख रहा हूँ और मेरा विज्ञान है या क्या है? What is this?
It is the contact of the eye. This thing with the something solid form that contact just that object is that chakshu vinyan sir when yeah. it is
good,
just
good.
Seen
so try better
it
good.
Is not Go that ahead. I am seeing it is just seen some thing is seen there is no sanya there is nothing else attached to it it's just the process of
try to make it more clear
Vinyan, I want to say all six sense doors, whatever we have in the past, we have understood, like your voice, I have heard. Ear, with ear sense door, I have recognized without seeing at you that Dhar Sahib ki awaaz hai.
That's not Vinyan. It will confuse. You are right what you are saying, but that's not Vinyan.
I want to say.
Recognition is Sanya. Recognition is Sanya. आपने शब्द सुना और पहचाना तो पहचानने का काम संज्ञा ने किया विज्ञान ने क्या किया विज्ञान का क्या फंक्शन है ना ताकि हम प्रिसाइजली समझ लें ना ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड इट प्रिसाइजली
कनेक्शन बिटवीन अस एंड द वर्ल्ड द वर्ल्डली
विज्ञान प्रोड्यूसेस कनेक्शन बिटवीन अस एंड वर्ल्ड नाउ दिस Is technically statement is not correct because we want to be precise, na? We want to be absolutely precise. हमने इतना discussion किया, तो we should be precise. What exactly is Buddha's teaching?
Sir, just knowing that I am touching these six things, just knowing that there is a sound, just knowing that the sixth one, which is the there is a thought.
Yeah.
Just knowing.
See, so. The process of just knowing it. So let's see, take with respect to these six sense objects and we define the six vinyans. Kya matlab hua chhe vinyan hoga? I didn't detail to you the experience, the whole process, na? Chakhu cha patichche rupe cha upajjati chakhu vinyanam. There is an eye, there is a form, dependent on eye and form and other conditions which we didn't spell out. there is arises chakshu vijnana. So it's a natural phenomena which arises when the eye is working, object is there and the light is there and the attention is there, various other conditions, and the person is alive and conscious, it's not unconscious. So then when all these conditions meet, then when there is eye, and so in description mein jo aata hai na, chakshu hai, form hai, un dono ke aapas mein sampark hone se, there is a sampark, not in the sense of physical touch, but that the attention is directed toward the object, then चक्षु विज्ञान arises. तो इसी तरह से आपने आवाज सुनी तो श्रोत विज्ञान उत्पन्न हुआ उस समय, आपने कुछ सुगंध सूंघी तो नाक पे विज्ञान, क्योंकि वो सुगंध जानने का काम नाक करती, क्या कहा जाता है नाक से होता है, उत्तर तो कॉन्शियसनेस करती है, बट एज ए इंस्ट्रूमेंट दिस इज द इंस्ट्रूमेंट, टंग इज द इंस्ट्रूमेंट, एट द टंग देर इज सम टच ऑफ द फूड, then there is a taste. So in this way, and there is a touch here, most dangerous thing, touch, and there is a hotabha vinyana, the kaya vinyana. Okay, there is a touch and there is a kaya vinyana. And there is a thought and there is a mano vinyana. Aur tino ka jo association hai, wo bhi humne discuss kiya tha, ki chakshu, object, और चक्षु विज्ञान, इन तीनों की कोऑर्डिनेशन को फस्स कहते हैं, कॉन्टैक्ट कहते ना डिस्कस, और उससे वेदना पैदा होगी, ऑटोमेटिक प्रोसेस में किसी का कोई बस नहीं चलेगा, देर विल बी वेदना, देर बी अ फीलिंग. सो दिस इज अ, हमने जब मधुपिंड का सुत्ता पढ़ा था ना, सारा डिटेल में आता था, चक्षु च पटच्च रूपे च उपजति चक्षु विज्ञानम तिन्नम संगति फस्स Hassa Pachaya Vedana, and then you can carry on the whole story. But these three, this is the definition aspect of it. So, kyunki hum sirf definition pe mehatva de rahe hain, aage paticcha samuppad ki baad mein baat karenge, abhi jitna karna utna hum samajh rahe hain ki kaise hamara jab bhi sansar se sampark hota hai, indriyon ke madhyam se sampark hoga, to jab bhi hoga to koi na koi indriya vigyan jagega, koi na koi हस्त जागेगा और कोई वेदना जागेगी. अब उस वेदना का हम क्या करते हैं वो आगे की बात, बट ये तो होने ही वाला है, और उस वेदना के जागने में उस हमारा परसेप्शन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल प्ले करेगा. अगर हम कोई चीज़ ऐसी देख रहे हैं जो आज तक कभी देखी ही नहीं है या सुनी नहीं है, तो फिर जो फीलिंग होगी बिकॉज ऑफ कंडीशनिंग्स, वो फीलिंग डिटर्मिन करेगी हमारे परसेप्शन को. हाँ नहीं, ये अच्छा लग रहा मुझे, ये आदमी अच्छा है, या ये भोजन अच्छा है, ये सुगंध अच्छी है, एंड सो ऑन. सो दैट्स हाउ परसेप्शन गेट्स फॉर्म्ड, एंड सो सो वी मस्ट सी द इंटर रिलेशनशिप ऑफ देम एंड सी दीज फाइव खंदास क्लियरली. तो साधना करते समय भी जितना जितना हद तक हम खंदों को अलग अलग देख पाएंगे, उतना उतना हमारा उनके साथ चिपकाव कम होता चला जाएगा. तो हमने अभी पढ़ा था संकितेन पंच उपादान खंदा दुखा, तो ये क्या मतलब हुआ इसका, अब आपको ये समझाना. हमने खंड तो समझ ली एक, तो अब वो कह रहे हैं संक्षेप में ये पांच उपादान खंड. उपादान का क्या मतलब हुआ याद है आपको? ग्रेस्पिंग, ग्रेस्पिंग, ओके,
ग्रेस्पिंग. स्कंदस वुड गिव अस
दुख. व्हाई?
दुख
क्यों?
ओके, डू यू वांट टू आंसर?
कैन यू एक्सप्लेन?
बिकॉज वी आइडेंटिफाई विद इट एज आवर्स, एज मी, as mine.
Oh, that's fine, yeah, they are mine, yeah. Sharir mera hai, ab kya isme kya dikkat? To identify karne se dukh kyon hoga?
Kyunki because uske sath clinging ka
maine bola na kuch,
kya bola? Ha, because of impermanence of the khand.
What else?
सेल्फ नहीं है,
वो किसमें हमने एक सूत्र पढ़ा था ना, किसमें इसकी चर्चा थी?
ये तो पांच उपादान
नहीं, हाँ किसमें इसकी चर्चा आती है? हम चैंटिंग में भी करते हैं ना, रोज रोज चैंट करते हैं ना, रूपम अनिच्चम वेदना अनिच्चा संज्ञा अनिच्चा संखारा अनिच्चा विज्ञानम अनिच्चा रूपम अनत्ता वेदना अनत्ता संज्ञा अनत्ता. तो वो चैंटिंग इसीलिए तो करते हैं, उसको याद रखनी चाहिए ना, है ना? Isn't it? So let's have a look at that part of the Anatta Lakhana Sutta, usko dekh lete hain saath saath, fir idhar aa jayenge. We'll just shift from one to another. Main aapko uska page number batata hu kahan pe uske bare mein aati hai baat, kyunki usme bhagwan ne achhi tarah samjhaya hua hai, to humko kisi ko bolne ki zarurat nahi hai. तो एक 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 चीज़ एक एक सेक्शन में पढ़ देता हूँ. जैसे रूप रूप वाला सेक्शन है पेज 120 पे, मैं पढ़ देता हूँ. आप ये सेकेंड पैराग्राफ जो है ना, रूपं भिक्खवे अनत्ता रूपं चहिदं भिक्खवे अत्ता अभविस्सा न इदं रूपं आबाधाय संवत्ते अलभ्येत च रूपे एवं मे रूपं होतु एवं मे रूपं मा अहोसि. आगे इसका ट्रांसलेशन क्या है, form bhikkhus is not self. If bhikkhus form were self, then form will not lead to affliction, and one might be able to say in regard to form, let my form be thus, let my form not be thus. But since bhikkhus form is not self, form therefore leads to affliction, and one is not able to say in regard to form, let my form be thus, let my form not be thus. And same thing applies to all other khandas. So this is one argument कि वो मेरे बस में नहीं है, है ना. बेसिकली वो कह रहे हैं कि आपके कंट्रोल में नहीं है, तो इसलिए उसको अपना नहीं कह सकते. किसी को आप अपना तब कह सकते हैं जब आपके कंट्रोल में कुछ तो हो उस पर. और क्या आर्ग्यूमेंट थी आगे, आगे वाले आर्ग्यूमेंट पढ़ लेते हैं. 122 नंबर पेज पे मैं पाली पढ़ देता हूँ, आप इंग्लिश पढ़ देना बाद में. तंखिम मन्यथ भिक्खवे रूपम निच्चम वा अनिच्चम वाति अनिच्चम भन्ते यम पाणिनिच्चम दुःखम वा तम सुखम वत्ति वाति दुःखम भन्ते यम पाणिनिच्चम दुःखम विपरिणाम धम्मम कल्लुम नतम संपन्न समनुपस्थितम एतं मम एसो अयम अस्मि एसो मे अत्ताति नो हेतम भन्ते. सो दिस इज अबाउट रूपा एंड सेम थिंग इज रिपीटेड अबाउट अदर्स. सो व्हाट इज द ट्रांसलेशन, पढ़ दीजिए आप. अनिश जी ट्रांसलेशन पढ़ दो 123 पेज पे, 123 नंबर पेज पे फॉर्म का पढ़ दो. एक दो तीन चौथा जो है ना, एक एक लाइन. व्हाट डू यू थिंक अबाउट दिस भिक्खुस,
हेलो मेंटल फॉर्मेशंस
नहीं 123 पे है ना, फॉर्म से शुरू कर देते.
व्हाट डू यू थिंक अबाउट दिस भिक्खुस, इज फॉर्म परमानेंट और इम्परमानेंट? इम्परमानेंट लॉर्ड, बट इज दैट व्हिच इज इम्परमानेंट पेनफुल और प्लेजरेबल? पेनफुल लॉर्ड, बट इज इट फिट टू कंसिडर दैट व्हिच इज इम्परमानेंट पेनफुल ऑफ अ नेचर टू चेंज? As this is mine, I am this, this is myself, it is not Lord.
And same thing is repeated about all of the khandas also. So this is the reason why we say sankhitte na panch upadana khanda dukkha. Theek hai, does it become clearer? Anything more anybody would like to add? Aapke
वी आर सेइंग कि वो इम्परमानेंट बाय इनका नेचर इम्परमानेंट है.
जी जी.
इसको अगर समझना चाहें प्रैक्टिकली,
जी,
तो हाउ डू वी अंडरस्टैंड इट प्रैक्टिकली? कि मान ली स्मेल, जैसे मैं कह रहा हूँ कि स्मेल एक मेरे अंदर, मतलब व्हेन दैट पर्टिकुलर सेंसेशन इज I'm aware about it, and then I'm saying that this is not permanent.
Yeah, because it will pass away. Change.
It will pass away.
आज तक कोई ऐसी smell है जो हमेशा बनी रही हो?
नहीं.
आपके संपर्क में आई हुई?
नहीं
आई
ना.
That is the basic hard fact. Although it is such a simple thing which we come across every moment of our life, we don't give attention to that. Smell, कोई भी चीज़ हो, taste हो, smell हो, touch हो, thought हो. सब कुछ
इट इज इम्परमानेंट टिल दैट happens again. For example, make an example that we are used to spray smells. Wo din mein rehti hai thodi der ke liye, uske baad khatam ho jati hai. Next day I again put it back. So is that
it's again.
I still call it impermanent, but my nature is making it permanent that I am getting
used
to it.
You can't. You can try it and make it permanent. You can't. Even if you keep your hand on the spray round the clock.
Round the clock.
It will not be permanent. That's right. It will change. You put an automatic controller, it will still change. You put the best possible thermostat in the human body, temperature will change. 0.1, 0.01, you may not be able to sense it, but it will change. It's a law of nature.
Now let's talk about touch. When we say touch,
and see. Touch it and see what happens. How long can you keep this touch? Can you keep it for eternity? You're sitting on the chair comfortably on a sofa. Perfectly comfortable. Best possible sofa of the world. How long will you sit on it? Impossible. Body is fundamentally of such kind that pain will arise even in the most comfortable posture. Because the internal dynamics of the body is such, it's changing, constantly changing. Body kahin pe bhi touch kar le, softest possible touch will also eventually become painful.
Ab dusra ye tha ki, since we have to put it practically for watching it in our own daily life. When we are not sitting for meditation and we are completely awake.
It doesn't need meditation to understand it. In fact, meditation can be a hindrance in understanding it. Because you are then enjoying, and especially when you become observe sensations and you get lost in it. You have no idea what is sanya, what is vedana, you have no idea what is sankhara, you're just enjoying.
So it's will it be possible ki main jaise mentally maine kisi se haath milaya aur main bahut garam joshi se haath mila raha hu aur ek feeling mere man mein aa rahi hai ki he is a very good friend and I am
feeling ho rahi hai
aur bahut achhi mujhe lag rahi hai uske sath, lekin achanak mere man mein vichar aaya ki ye impermanent hai. Because the moment I will leave.
विचार आने की जरूरत नहीं, वो है impermanent. आप हाथ हाथ उसका हाथ पकड़ के रखे, कहिए मैं आज impermanent को disprove करके रहूंगा. आप करके देख लीजिए कितनी देर तक पकड़े रखेंगे हाथ, कितनी देर.
मैं वो कह रहा हूँ कि इसका जो माइंड पे इफेक्ट पड़ता है, जो हमारी डे टू डे एक्टिविटी पे, वो एक नेगेटिव इफेक्ट नहीं पड़ेगा कि मैं मतलब जैसे ही मेरे को लगा कि ये मैंने हाथ मिलाया और बड़ी गर्म जोशी से मिलाया और मेरे मन में विचार आया कि impermanent है दिस पर्सन विद हुम आई एम बड़ी गर्म जोशी से मिल रहा हूँ, अभी ये इम्परमानेंट है मेरा रिलेशनशिप इनके साथ और ये थोड़ी देर में ही ये सब ये अनित्य है. तो अगर ये मैं अनित्य का भाव इतना ज्यादा जगा दूंगा अपनी लाइफ के अंदर, तो इज इट नॉट गोइंग टू मेक मी कम्प्लीटली डिसइंटरेस्टेड एंड डिसिल्यूजन्ड विद द वर्ल्ड.
लैक ऑफ प्रज्ञा ना, दैट्स अ लैक ऑफ प्रज्ञा, दैट्स अ लैक ऑफ विजडम. अनित्य इज नॉट अ कर्स, इट इज अ रियलिटी. Impermanence is not a curse on us, it is the reality. Imagine if the body did not decay, what will happen to us? What will happen to this earth? Bloody, it will just get destroyed. So it is a benediction of the nature that things are impermanent, that we arise and pass away. Otherwise things will not sustain. Impossible. And when we realize it, the impermanence of relationships, we try to make it as good as possible. We try to make them as nice as possible. We try to avoid, forget about unnecessary, unpleasant occurrences and remember the pleasant ones. Because you know it's impermanent. यार आज मिला है, पता नहीं कल मिलेगा कि नहीं. अब क्या उससे झगड़ा करना है मुझे, पुरानी बात लेके. Let me be friendly to him. It's a question of how you look at it, isn't it? If one has a strongly craving temperament, na, राग मूलित लोभ मूल दोष वाला लोभ वाला चरित्र है, लोभ चरित्र से क्या ना, स्ट्रॉन्ग अटैचमेंट एंड यू टच समबडी हुम यू लाइक एंड देन यू फील वंडरफुल, इट शुड नॉट गो अवे. दैट इज क्रेविंग, एक्चुअली दैट इज वेयर क्रेविंग अराइजेस. सो इफ यू आर वाइज वील सी ओ इम्परमानेंस इज देयर, आई शुड नॉट क्रेव फॉर इट. डिडंट इट हैपेंस यू नो, ए चाइल्ड इज लिविंग अब्रॉड फॉर 20 ईयर्स, ही कम्स होम, यू फील सो हैप्पी. And if you feel happy and then you wish, no, you should not go back, you will be in deep trouble. When he goes back, for 10 days you will be in depression. So we have to understand that. It's a hard fact. It is really a hard fact. And it's not, it's true of every action, every moment of our life. We should be aware of that. The more we are aware with wisdom, there's no substitute for wisdom. There's no substitute for right thinking. There's no substitute for sammaditti. There's just no substitute. You can do whatever you like. Howsoever great meditations you can do. It's just not, there's no substitute for that. Mindfulness by itself is not enough. Sampanya is required. If you don't have that, we'll become expert observers of that gatekeepers who saw the thieves taking away things and entering and taking away. So wisdom is very important. So, sankhittena panch upadana khanda dukkha. Alright. Anything else anybody would like to add to explain it better?
So can we say that our mind adopts the situations and again goes to moderate stage as something we see from eyes and or smell something, and after some moment we again the brain goes into neutral stage. The smell is still there, but we are not sensing now.
No, you see, we should first, as kyunki main nivedan kar raha hu na, hum shabdon ko bahut samajh soch soch ke select karke bole. Brain is just an instrument, so we should not use that, isn't it? It is just an instrument, just as eye is an instrument. We are talking about the rupa. Brain is a rupa. It is an instrument for sensing various things, complex instrument. तो जो मन की बात आप कह रहे हैं ना, तो जो ये विज्ञान है, वेदना है, संज्ञा है, संखार है, ये सब माइंड हमारे, जिस सबको एक तरह से ओमनिबस टर्म के रूप में मन कहा जाता है सामान्य तौर पे, है ना? तो ये मटीरियल एंटिटीज नहीं है, दे आर इमटीरियल नॉन मटीरियल एंटिटीज. सो वी कैनॉट यूज द सेम लैंग्वेज for them as we use for a matter. Now when you are saying that you observe something and it automatically goes to neutral state, it is not automatic. It depends on how I respond. कोई जब मैंने किसी को देखा, विज्ञान जागा, वेदना जागी, अब उस वेदना के प्रति मेरी क्या प्रतिक्रिया होगी उस पर निर्भर करेगा कि मेरा मन एक्साइटमेंट में जाएगा, डिप्रेशन में जाएगा, या इक्वानिमिटी में जाएगा, है ना? वो उस मेरे प्रतिक्रिया पे डिपेंड करेगा, ऑटोमेटिक नहीं होगा. सो दिस इशू ऑफ फाइव खंदास एंड उनके प्रति जो उपादान है, इसको समझना बहुत आवश्यक है, क्योंकि उस उपादान का मतलब है कि हम उससे अपने आप को आइडेंटिफाई कर रहे हैं. वी आर ग्रेस्पिंग इट एज मी एंड माइन. And that's why he said, अभी हमने पढ़ा था ना इसमें, मैं तत्मम ने स्वम अस्मि. भगवान ने कहा था ना कि अगर ये है तो ये ऐसा कहना क्या ठीक है कि ये 122 में था ना, यम पन निचम दुखम विपरिणाम दम्मम, जो अनित्य है, बदलता रहता है, दुख का कारण है, क्या उसके बारे में ये कहना ठीक है, एतंग मम एसो हम अस्मि एसो मे अत्ताति, ये दिस इज माइन, दिस आई एम, दिस इज माई सेल्फ. नाउ दिस इज ए मंत्र, आई यूज इट सो लाइक ए मंत्र वेन एवर आई इंटरेक्ट विद द वर्ल्ड. यू हैव पुट ना इन इट, नेतंग मम नेसो हम अस्मि न मेसो अत्ताति, एनीथिंग व्हाट्स एवर. 122-123 का लास्ट 2 and 123 का उसका ट्रांसलेशन है. नहीं, यहाँ पे तो एतंग मम है ना, उन्होंने नो हेतम कहा. ये भगवान ने तो कहा कि क्या ये कहना ठीक है कि ये मैं हूँ, मेरे मैं, ये मेरा है, मेरे मैं हूँ और ये मेरी अत्ता है. तो कह रहे हैं नहीं, ऐसा नहीं है. तो सत्य क्या है, इसका अपोजिट है. तो इनफैक्ट for every khanda and for every interaction whatever we have in the world, we can use this as a reminder. Netang mang, this is not mine. Neso ahamasmi, this is not me. Neso mattati, this is not myself. So, to ye baat jo hai, bahut mahatvapurna baat hai, which should be seen as a very important antidote to. So this is an antidote to sankhitena panch upadana khanda dukkha. Jo hum usko panch upadan ke prati attachment karte hain, grasp karte hain, usko todne ke liye is baat pe reflect karna bahut mahatvapurna, bahut helpful hai ki ye meri nahi hai, ye sharir, vedana, sanya, sankhar, vinyan, kuch bhi mera nahi hai. It's a natural phenomena. So, इसीलिए फिर हमने आपको याद होगा इसके बाद अनात्म के ऊपर काफी चर्चा की थी. तो मैं उसी डायरेक्शन में चलते हुए. नहीं, you have no chance to ask questions. Sorry. You can put it at the end. तो हमने जब अनात्म की चर्चा की थी तो मैंने कुछ फोटो दिखाई थी. मैं सिर्फ फोटो दिखा के आपकी मदद के लिए फोटो दिखा रहा हूँ. वैसे मुझे आपको शायद ये भी नहीं करना चाहिए था, बट बताना चाहिए, अच्छा रहेगा. ये फोटो दिखाई थी आपको, याद आता है इससे? अनात्म समझने के लिए हमने क्या कहा था इसको, कि ये मैं नहीं हूँ. हाँ, तो हमने कहा था भाई कार जो है एक कॉन्सेप्ट है ना. इसमें कार कहाँ है? हम इसको कहते हैं कार. याद आपको? एक्सप्लेन करो. चलो मोनिका प्लीज गो अहेड. उसके दो डबल करना पड़ता था, वो भरा था.
जो एग्जांपल आपने दिया था तो उसमें बहुत सारे पार्ट्स थे उस कार के जो डिसइंटीग्रेटेड थे. तो अगर हम कहें कि कार ये है या कार वो है, क्योंकि वो बहुत सारे पार्ट्स हैं, तो वो एक परसेप्शन जो हमारा जनरेट हो रहा है. एंड देन हम
तो इसको सिर्फ इतने पे बात नहीं थी, हमने उसको गहराई से समझने की कोशिश की थी. नहीं, कार के बारे में भी
जी.
आपको याद होगा उसकी जो सिस्टर वजीरा का एक कोटेशन था कि जैसे एक चैरियट है या कार है, कार के अन्य अन्य पुर्जे हैं, उनको जोड़ के जो समुच्चय बनता है उसको कार कहते हैं. उनमें से कोई भी चीज कार नहीं है, ये कार था ना
जी.
ठीक है ना
जी.
तो कार क्या हुई? एक कॉन्सेप्ट है जिसमें कि ये सारे पार्ट जुड़े हुए हैं. तो जो हम पर्सन कहते हैं, मैं हूँ, वो एक कॉन्सेप्ट है जिसमें पांच खंड जुड़े हुए हैं
जी.
ऐसे समझने की कोशिश की थी. इसी तरह फिर हमने ये ह्यूमन बॉडी को भी समझा था, ये देखा था
जी.
तो आप इसको देख के बताइए कौन सा मैं हूँ. तो क्या इससे हम इस डायग्राम से क्या समझने की कोशिश की थी हमने?
अगेन अ परसेप्शन व्हाट वी डिराइव्ड और वी क्रिएट एज अ पर्सन. देयर इज नो सेल्फ देन.
इसमें यू कैन नॉट
सामान्यता तो हम आइडेंटिफाई अपने को शरीर से ही करते हैं ना. अब सब एक दूसरे को कैसे आइडेंटिफाई करते हैं? शरीर से आइडेंटिफाई करते हैं. तो यहाँ पे इस फोटो दिखाने का क्या तात्पर्य था?
कि आप किस चीज पे पिन पॉइंट करके कहोगे ये मैं हूँ? लंग में हूँ, हार्ट में हूँ, बोन में हूँ, किस चीज से आइडेंटिफाई करके बोलोगे कि दिस इज मी?
इसको हम लोग भगवान जो है वो 32 पार्ट वाली जो बात है ना उससे करते हैं. तो उसको थोड़ा सा एक बार हम पढ़ लेते हैं, वो अच्छा रहेगा. सो दैट वी कैन रिलेट इट टू द टीचिंग्स. सो सॉरी, इसमें तो 42 पेज है, इसमें देखता हूँ मैं, एक मिनट देखता हूँ. होगा 30-35 होगा कहीं. छियालीस नंबर पेज है देखिए. तो यहाँ पे तो हमने इतने सारे टुकड़े टुकड़े करके दिखा दिए. तो भगवान ने उसकी इस साधना के लिए 32 पार्ट का जो डिस्क्रिप्शन है ना, दिस विच इज माई बॉडी फ्रॉम द सोल्स ऑफ द फीट अप एंड डाउन फ्रॉम द क्राउन ऑफ द हेड इज अ सील्ड बैग ऑफ स्किन फिल्ड विद अनअट्रैक्टिव थिंग्स. यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज अ सील्ड बैग फिल्ड विद ऑल दैट स्टफ. तो यहाँ पे भगवान क्या करते हैं, एक बार इसको चैंट कर लेते हैं। आपको इंग्लिश में बोल दीजिए। चलिए, यस मनीषा, गो अहेड, टेक द माइक, माइक इज नियर यू, जस्ट डू इट इन इंग्लिश, इट्स ऑल राइट, बिकॉज पाली वर्ड्स मे नॉट बी इजिली रिकॉग्नाइज। Yeah.
This which is my body.
Yeah. Go ahead.
From the soles of the feet up and down, from the crown of the head, is a sealed bag of skin filled with unattractive things. In this body there are hair of the head, hair of the body, nails, teeth, skin, flesh, sinews, bones, bone marrow, kidney, heart, liver, membranes, spleen, lungs, bowels, entrails, undigested food, excrement, bile, phlegm, pus, blood, sweat, fat, tears, grease, spittle, mucus, oil of the joints, urine, brain. This then which is my body, from the soles of the feet up and down, from the crown of the head, is a sealed bag of skin filled with unattractive things.
So this is the kind of reflection which is helpful in reducing the attachment to the body. आपने समझा था ना कि इसीलिए किया जाता है कि शरीर के प्रति जो attraction है, lust है, वो इस समझ से कम हो सकती है। और हमने इसको सामान्य विज्ञान से भी जोड़ने की कोशिश की थी, जो आजकल का आधुनिक विज्ञान है, उससे भी तो कुछ और insight मिलती है। मैं आपको फोटो दिखा देता हूँ, पूछता हूँ कि आपको याद है क्या ये जो फोटो हमने आप देखी थी वहाँ पे, इससे क्या निष्कर्ष निकाला था? Does anybody remember?
Somebody who can see the atoms. And see the, this is the way you can see the body.
So what does it mean? What does it help? Supposing we all develop that eyesight of X-ray vision and you can see the like electron microscope and see electrons. So, usse kya hamare ko perception?
We all are interconnected actually, because we can't say that I end here and you begin there.
Do you understand that? Do you all, are you able to understand that? Iska implication kya hai? Iska implication kya hai?
Nothing but a big picture. I'm like seeing the color of that seashore. We are one
cohesive unit with the nature, but we look at photo frames which we draw out and think this is me. Divide it into smaller things and...
This was another photo which I had shown you.
Part
you
of
remember?
Nature.
If you see in the entirety with respect to... हमने चार धातुओं की बातें की थी ना, क्या क्या चार धातुओं की बातें होती हैं? सो व्हाट इज अ ट्री मेड अप ऑफ एंड व्हाट इज अ ह्यूमन बॉडी मेड अप ऑफ, इज देयर अ डिफरेंस?
सो इट्स द सेम एलिमेंट्स व्हिच द ट्री इज मेड अप ऑफ एंड
ऑल मैटर इज मेड अप ऑफ द सेम फोर एलिमेंट्स। इफ यू वांट टू पुट आकाश यू कैन पुट दैट आल्सो। So we understand that the attachment to the body is primarily because we are not seeing it properly. We are not able to look at it properly. Whether you look at it from 32 parts, which are apparently easily to see, you have the hair, we have the body hair, you have the nose, you have the lungs, you have the bones, you have the spleen. So you can see them all, to some extent at least. So you can see this is just a collection of the various parts, and therefore to call them as mine is quite tough, especially in modern times of replacement of limbs and replacement of kidneys and replacement of heart, and I don't know whose heart goes where and whose kidney goes where and what happens to the person. So you can see the futility of trying to identify with the body. So ye sare tareeke hain humko ye samajhne ke ki न ये तत् मम न ये सो अमस्मी न मे सो अत्ता थी, दिस बॉडी इज नॉट मी, नॉट माइन, नॉट माई सेल्फ। एंड सिमिलरली वी कैन सी विद रिस्पेक्ट टू अदर खंदास। But because attachment to body is very strong, we try to understand it. And then I had shown you this picture also. Do you remember? Have a look at that video. What does it mean? What was it showing? Yeah. What is the relevance of it in understanding anatta? Anybody remembers? इससे हमको अनत्ता की बात कैसे समझ में आती है?
It's a whirlpool. It shows that whirlpool is moving. It's all water. Just movement creates that whirlpool. Similarly, in living beings, that is in humans, if we are doing something and we attach all things with ourselves and we say that's what we are doing, that is aham. Aham is coming in us. I can't understand. But the,
or the sannyasa. Or koi? Yeah, it's a good attempt. Or koi? Because this analogy of a whirlpool is a very powerful analogy. I have काफी कोशिश की थी समझाने की.
Like we say that ये जो leaves का हमने देखा और उसमें कहा कि it is all the same. हम भी और पेड़ भी हम सब का जो matter है. In the same way water है, whirlpool भी पानी के ही बीच में से निकला है. It's also basic characteristic इसका भी वही है. It's water, but इसकी formation कुछ कंडीशन की वजह से ऐसी इसकी फॉर्मेशन हो गई है. वो कंडीशन हट जाएगी तो ये वो हट जाएगा. इट्स अ टेम्प्रेरी फिनोमिना दैट हैज अकर्ड बिकॉज ऑफ द विद इन द वाटर इटसेल्फ. दो इट इज वाटर प्योरली देयर.
सो व्हेन वी ट्रांसप्लांट, वेरी गुड, लेट अस ट्रांसप्लांट दिस टू आवर एग्जिस्टेंस नाउ. व्हाट इज द कंडीशन व्हिच इज कॉजिंग दिस व्हर्लपूल कॉल्ड पीएलआर टू रोटेट अराउंड life after life, life after life. I had given that also, explained that. भगवान ने कहा ना कि क्या है, हम हैं क्या. उन्होंने who am I का जवाब नहीं दिया, what am I का जवाब दिया है. आपको अगर याद हो. Yeah, good.
Series of karma.
What does it mean? What does he say? Or what are you? There was a I had paraphrased it, if you remember, and you can put it in your own words. How does the karma become a condition for the vortex to arise? Good, try it out.
No, I didn't get the question.
ये जो vortex है, ये कहा कि पानी की कुछ conditions ऐसी हो गई जिसके कारण एक form बन गया. दिख रहा है हमें, फॉर्म है नहीं बट दिख रहा है. और वो इसके बड़ा पावरफुल चीज है वॉर्टेक्स, आपको पता है ना, उसमें अगर कुछ भी चला जाए तो वो सक करके नीचे ले जाता है. इट्स नॉट ए माइनर थिंग, इट्स अ वेरी पावरफुल स्टफ, इट कैन सिंक इन बोट्स. सो इसी तरह से ह्यूमन बीइंग इज ऑल्सो, ह्यूमन बॉडी इज ऑल्सो सीन लाइक अ व्हर्लपूल. इफ यू सी इट, रिफ्लेक्ट अपॉन इट, कॉन्स्टेंटली थिंग्स आर गोइंग अप एंड डाउन. ब्लड इज फ्लोइंग up and down, breath is going in, coming out, and other fluids are also moving in their own way. So they're all in motion. There's no stagnation here. So our whole body is also like a big whirlpool. And what is the cause for that? I tried to point out from Buddha's teachings. You remember? We are essentially, we chant, you know, let us see it. Every day we chant it. I'm trying to relate it to that so that you can, because here it is kammasya, you know, we remember the chant for kamma, kammasya koma. Let's remember it and use that. Acha isme hum dekh le jaye, main bar bar usme dekh leta hu. Kammasya ka kamma daya da kamma yoni. Yeah, 44 pe chaliye, isko padhte hain, chant karte hain. 44 का लास्ट पैराग्राफ है. इसको पाली में भी कर दो यार, बहुत अच्छा लगता है. जस्ट रिमेंबर, इट्स गुड टू रिमेंबर दैट. सो हु वुड डू इट? पेज 44, ये किताब जो है ना, इसमें 44 नंबर पेज पे. हाँ जी, कमल जी चांट करिए आप पाली में फिर इंग्लिश में माइक दे दीजिए उनको
ये वाला ना कम सको अमही कम दाया दो कम योनि कम बंधु कम पटिसरणा यं कम मंग करिष्यामि कल्याणं वा पापकं वा तस्य दायादो भविष्यामि
ट्रांसलेशन कर दी
एवं अमहेहि
नहीं नहीं ट्रांसलेशन कर
अच्छा ये आई एम दी ओनर ऑफ माय कम्मास हेयर टू माय कम्मास born of my kammas related to my kammas abide supported by my kammas whatever kamma I shall do for good or for ill of what I will be the heir
kya kaha jata hai kammas komhi kamma daya do kamma yoni what does the word kamma yoni mean kamma is the womb from which I emerge So it is the kamma from which I am emerging again and again and again. Wholesome or unwholesome kamma and I keep on manifesting in various forms. And that's it. And why does the kamma arise? Why do we do kamma? Basically, just to broaden the scope because probably there's the time. Because we want to flow against the law of nature. Why does the vortex form? Because water, some part of the water is trying to flow against the law of nature. River is flowing down. Somehow there is some disturbance somewhere and water is trying to go upstream. And then what river pushes it, it goes down. Then it again tries and you have a whirlpool which can sink in a ship if you like. Exactly same thing in a figurative sense is happening with our lives. We are trying to swim against the law of nature. We see permanence in when there is impermanence. We see happiness where there is dukkha, we see person where there is none, and these three basic delusions, three basic ignorances, we want to go up against the stream of nature. We want to be permanent, and we are not ready to accept impermanence, and therefore we want to flow against the stream of nature. And the nature is powerful; it takes us around, and so this vortex of spinning around from life to life—that's what is called sansara. Sansara actually means. Going round and round, sansaran kar raha hai, ek life se dusre life, dusre life. And this is what is happening to all of us, isn't it? That's why this vortex simile is very powerful. Bhikkhu Nyanananda has given this in explanation of some of the suttas. Very powerful analogy. You can just reflect on it. Just reflect on it means just see that what's going on in my life. Kamma, wholesome and unwholesome kamma, and they are the yoni. Buddha is telling us. Kamma kumasya komi, I am the owner of them. Kamma daya do, I am the heir root, I am the inheritor of it. Jo kaam hai, uspo meri inheritance hai. There is nothing I can do about it. And as long as there is a karma done, wholesome or unwholesome, I will reap the fruits of it. So eventually, what does it mean to be free? No karma should be done. There should be complete abdication of sense of self. As long as there is a sense of self, there is a karma. So sankhara is also one of the important dimensions of sankhara is karma. Kamma is the sankhara. Volition, whatever we do with volition becomes a sankhara. And that becomes the kamma. And that will take us round and round and round. It's not just that unwholesome karma. We may do very good wholesome karma, but with the sense of I, sense of self, they will also keep us going round and round and round. You can't get out of it. So you have to understand, Panch Upadana Khanda Dukkha is a very powerful reflection. That as long as the sense of self remains, we are tied to this cycle of birth and death. There is no way you can get out of it. You can, of course, by doing wholesome karma, you can have a good life, pleasant situations, pleasant circumstances. But Jati Pi Dukkha, Jara Pi Dukkha, Maranam Pi Dukkham, nobody is going to escape it. So that's the way we create dharma samveg in us, so that we are really motivated to follow the path with earnestness, with sincerity, and give it the highest priority in our life. So this is the purpose of all that discussion, you know. What are we really aiming for in our life? Stress relief, peace and tranquility, or liberation?
Is it possible to do with some mic?
Please take mic. It take a few seconds.
Yeah. Is it possible to do wholesome karma without the sense of I?
Yeah, of course, why not?
Like,
certainly. And all of us do sometimes. It's not that it's something impossible and only an arhant can do. Many times we do such things. You're moved by compassion and you do actions. You don't do it because I will gain something out of it. Isn't it? There are moments when all of us do it. It's not, of course, fully realized being will always do action out of that, or moved by compassion, moved by loving kindness, moved by mudita. So the four what are called Brahma Viharas, three of them become, or two of them actually become the source of action. So presently, in the sense of self, there is I do a donation, I do a good deed, I expect, oh, kuch to mujhe bhi fayda hoga. It's obviously a wholesome thing than doing an unwholesome action. But as the sense of self attenuates, as we understand Netad Mam Nesuam Asmi Namesu, and we chant it and understand it. We're chanting it but not putting it in. So take it in. That's all. That's the purpose of chanting. So as we take it in, more and more, the sense of self sort of, it's just a question of rubbing it off. Slowly rubbing it off. We don't have so much of past parmi and the wisdom that we can just drop it right away. I talk of myself, of course. Maybe somebody has. So it takes time to slowly rub it off. And it does become, within our own experience, we find many a times we do actions which are not motivated by anything other than compassion is driving you to do an action. Compassion is the best source for, can be the best source for wholesome karma without a sense of self. If you are really moved by somebody, when your son is critically ill, you won't bother about what should I do and what will I gain out of it and what will I do. You know, you are moved by that. So that's the issue.
And just I was thinking, as you were saying about karma, Buddha said somewhere there is no life of you can't trace, you know, where life began.
Yeah,
so if we say it's infinite, so we have made infinite karma. So whatever we do right now, good, bad, it adds to infinite. So it's like infinite mass of, I don't know, good, bad karma.
It's not that we have to take a weighing scale and remove one by one, you know. It doesn't happen like that. The understanding of anatta, that's why the importance is given to that understanding. There is a very beautiful analogy given by Venerable Lady Sayadaw. He says our karma are like white and black beads which are in a big garland. Okay? And those white and black beads are held by the garland, by the string. And one way is you remove one by one the beads, remove them. Other is you cut the string. The whole bead will scatter out. He says cutting the string is penetration into the nature of anatta, because it is atta which holds that all these karma together. So this is beautiful, and explanation he gave in his Vipassana Deepini. I remember it so well. So that's a powerful way of understanding. So it's not that when we practice meditation and you do gradually reduce these craving, you have feelings which are unpleasant, you don't react, so you reduce the unpleasant mental tendencies, the anushaya klesha, the latent tendencies, gradually reduce them. So gradually the ignorance gets reduced. But when you break through and cut out the sense of self deeply, then it just vanishes like it. It just drops off. Because there is no holder of the mind. That's why in this Thai tradition, Ajahn Chah, Ajahn Sumedho, keep on saying, if you think you have a a huge amount of karma to take care, you have a lot of craving, you have a lot of aversion, and you will work hard and you will meditate to remove your craving, your aversion, and then you will become enlightened. You're done. There's no way you can get out of it. Because you are holding on to that you and you and you. So with that deep understanding that these phenomena are arising impersonally, you see, that's why these khandas, he is talking again, anatta lakkhana sutta dhamma chakkapo. He is saying again, things which are not in your control, are they yours? He is talking of all the khanda, they are not yours. But we say, no, they are mine. You see, we don't believe him. He says, the sankhara is not yours. But we say, no, this craving is mine, this aversion is mine. And of course, it's not easy to see because it seems like that. It grips us all together. But understanding has to show its effect slowly, slowly, slowly. It should show its effect. So it's not a hopeless task there. Okay? Mic de diye.
Sir, one of the thing which possibly is also, I think, what drishta and akarta, the bhav of watching and not the bhav of karta. In the sense, in even in the drishta, over a period of time, many a times, there's a feeling, almost lack of energy in any doing anything many a times. And it also happens, I mean, it has happened on and off for me, where I have no interest in doing action. And is it something which is also where slowly and gradually it's a journey, and from there the realization that the action itself or any interest is also need to be watched and not necessarily, there is something in it.
The drishta bhava is a step in the direction of liberation, but it's not the final step. There's no drishta. We have to really understand there's no drishta. So that we have to really transcend that drishta. That is the final kind of jump which has to be made. There's no drishta here. Things are just happening as a part of the nature, natural phenomena, just as we said. Yeah, trees and human beings and trees and leaves, that's our constitution. So, arising of craving, arising of aversion is also part of nature. External circumstances, latent tendencies, all put together and create a craving, create an aversion. And since we grasp that, then it becomes a problem. Regarding your other question of whether the movement in the direction will lead to lethargy and inaction, no, it won't. And then lethargy in action can be nivaranas, you know, hindrances which arise. These are the part of the process of purification. The obstructions to meditation, nivaranas, one of them is this lethargy, dullness of body, dullness of mind. So it should be seen in that direction. We know of people who are generally believed to be fully enlightened, and if you see his level of work at the age of 77, I mean, you can't really match it. So it's not that it leads to inaction. So we have evidence available to that effect. Okay. And this was the last diagram which I had shown you, I think. You remember? Yes, I think she had referred to. So she should explain it better. Now, go ahead. What was that diagram and why was it used? What for was it used?
We are all a part of nature, we perceive ourselves as individuals, and therefore this is one scene which is, so when we draw frames, this is what we identify. That one is Surbhi, that one is Manisha, that one is Dharsar, this one is Arpan, this one is Shivam, and that is how we start to identify ourselves with it. Whereas if you take out the photo frames, we are just one, yeah.
So, that's how the notion of drawing the boundaries, because we are not in a position to see that these apparent boundaries are not, they are apparent, they are not real. They seem to be real, but they're not really, they're not real. The air which we breathe in, the food which we eat, it all comes from four elements. It comes from earth, water, fire, sun, earth, water, air. That's it. Everything is made up of that eventually in the root cause. So the notion of I, what we call as Sakkaya, that arises because of this framing. You are framing up, identifying with the body, mostly with the body, and then we become an identify with the mind and the various facets of it. Okay? Then we had asked this question. And we have tried to understand it. So, who will explain it now? Of course, partly we have explained it.
Yeah, but this question, who am I? This question, who am I? This, when you would explain this, you said that Buddha had reframed it to what am I instead of who am I? And it was. What it was, series of continuing karma. That is what he had said. And what we just read, the chanting that we just read was the answer to it.
But we went beyond that also in the class. Remember what we did in the class in order to understand who is reborn, who reaps the fruit of karma? Can anybody explain?
The sanskar is the thing that reborns, sanskara.
Yeah, but we try to understand it in detail. No?
Yes.
Okay, let me show you the. Let me give you a hint. I had drawn this diagram. आपने देखा था?
हाँ, देखा देखा.
अब इससे कुछ hint मिला?
ये नहीं, but
कुछ और याद आया था. बाकी the right hand side, सारा left hand side पे जा रहा. Right hand side पे जवाब नहीं आ रहे. अनिश जी कुछ जवाब देंगे पीछे शांति जी शांति जी तो क्लासों में थे सब इस पिक्चर से कुछ आइडिया आया क्या हमने डिस्कस किया था
इससे नहीं याद आया मगर एक चीज आपने बोली
एक और लाइन बता
संस्कार
एक और लाइन डाल दीजिए
धम्मा
थ्योरी कुछ कहा था ना धम्मा के बारे में कुछ कहा था
न्यूक्लियस हर
याद आया कि नहीं
बट आपने इसमें भवं चित्त और उसकी चित्त की बात की थी कि अजीबवा से ये
अब इसको रिलेट करो ना ये जो डायग्राम बनाया है ये डायग्राम किस लिए बनाया था
क्वार्क के लिए बनाया था
वो क्या है क्वार्क है क्या
सबसे स्मॉलेस्ट पार्टिकल ऑफ एग्जिस्टेंस है
ऑफ मैटर
ऑफ
मैटर धम्मा थ्योरी क्या थी उसी तरह से
चित्त
को और जो अनुभव है हमारे अनुभवों को समझने के लिए जो भी अनुभव होता है उसको धम्म कहा
हाँ।
और उसको फिर हमने एनालाइज किया था किस तरह कितने तरह के धम्म हैं और धम्म जो है बेसिक एक्सपीरियंस है हमारा इन्फिनिटेसिमल एक्सपीरियंस विच अराइजेज एंड पासिस अवे तो उसको कहा कि हमने चित्त है एक धम्म चेतसिक है और रूप है और निब्बान है रूप चित्त चेतसिक जो है कंडीशन धम्म है निब्बाना अनकंडीशन धम्म है रूप जो है जैसे हमने डिस्कस किया तो इट इज जस्ट पुटिंग इट टुगेदर यू मस्ट रिमेंबर दिस ना रूप इज द फॉर्म द मैटर विच इज कंप्राइज्ड ऑफ एलिमेंट्स अर्थ एयर फायर वाटर एंड स्पेस इफ यू वॉन्ट पुट इट टुगेदर And then chitta is what is called the consciousness or the vijnana. And chetsika are the adjuncts of vijnana. ठीक है ना adjuncts मतलब जो mental factors जिसको कहे थे हमने तो चित्त तो हो गया विज्ञान और दूसरे mental factor हो गए वेदना संन्यास लोभ दोष मोह ये सब सती they are all mental factors. They all arise and pass away, constantly arise and pass away. तो हमारा चित्त जो है वो भी प्रतिक्षण अराइज होता है पास और जो अगला चित्त आता है वो पिछले चित्त से कंडीशनड होता है इमीडिएटली तो उससे होता है और भी पास्ट से भी होता है वो और कॉम्प्लिकेटेड था उसको हमने छोड़ दिया था तो प्रतिक्षण वो हो रहा है तो हम जब कहते हैं हु इज रिबॉर्न, तो इसका क्या हमने इस इतना समझाने से आगे आप चला सकते हैं इसको? प्रतिक्षण क्या हो रहा है हमारे, जैसे हम बात कर रहे हैं जीवित हैं। कमल जी करिए एक्सप्लेन, ट्राई इट आउट, बिकॉज इफ यू आर if you have that clarity, it helps a lot in practice and removing doubts of the issues. He'll explain, Kamalji will explain.
हर एक चित्त ही उत्पन्न हो रहा है हर एक अवस्था में, और नहीं सर बताइए
चलो अर्पण जी।
सो एज आई अंडरस्टैंड इट, इन एवरी माइंड मोमेंट देर इज अ सर्टन वोल्यूशन अराइजिंग विच वी कॉल चित्ता, एंड दैट ट्रिगर्स एंड कंडीशंस द इमीडिएटली नेक्स्ट चित्ता. So the root, the seeds of what will arise in the next moment are from the previous one, and this happens in this live stream, and then exactly is what continues in the next live stream. So basically, if I'm not the body-mind complex, what is essentially reborn and what reaps the fruit of karma is just this, that in this moment there is a certain, way the chitta is, and that influences the next moment and so on and so forth. So it's basically a impersonal succession of chittas that are arising, consciousnesses that are arising. That's essentially how we see it. So we can see it in this lifetime and we can see it across lifetimes. So actually when we do jati pe dukkha, that's true, it means birth is dukkha, but it's also that the way my mind is just now will also condition my next moment and moments and so forth. So one can also understand dukkha in that way, but that's a digression. But the immediate response is this basically.
Anybody else? Koi aur? Haan, boliye. Koi bhi add karna chahe isme samajhne ke liye?
So I think what whatever at this moment I'm attaching myself either to any of those six khandas, that will be the seed for the next moment. So if it, at this moment I am just watching and not participating or engaging in it, then in my understanding, I am at least, if not eliminating, but reducing. So possibly I am going towards the direction of, as you've mentioned, that cutting that cord. So not engaging and participating would be my understanding of the perspective of Anchitta.
Let me use the board to graphically illustrate it. I think that helps, at least it helps me, so maybe it will help you. You see, the process of mind moments can be seen as arising. I mean, some people say it's staying and then passing away. Of course, I'm showing it on a very large scale. This is a time. So a chitta arises, stays for certain time, very small time, and passes away. Now this time interval is extremely small. Less than a millisecond, or even, I don't know, we don't know, but extremely small. So yahan pe jab chitta utpann hua, kuch kshan ke liye ruka, aur phir samapt ho gaya, to uske baad phir दूसरा चित्त जागा, फिर वो, और ये जो यहाँ से चित्त से इधर दूसरा चित्त जो जागा, ये इस के मोटिव फोर्स जो इसके अंदर जो एनर्जी थी या जो इसमें मोमेंटम था इसका चित्त का, उससे अगला चित्त जाग गया उसके अंदर से, और ये प्रोसेस निरंतर चलती रहेगी। अब हमको ये इंडिविजुअली दिख नहीं पाता ऐसे, क्यों नहीं दिख पाता, क्योंकि टाइम इंटरवल बहुत कम है, हमारा टाइम स्केल है 1 सेकंड, ज़्यादा बहुत ही शार्प माइंड है तो भाई 1 सेकंड में क्या हुआ हमें मालूम पड़ जाएगा, वो भी नहीं मालूम पड़ता, नहीं वैसे 10-15 सेकंड में मालूम पड़ता है, तो 10-15 सेकंड में ये करोड़ों मूवमेंट हो जाएंगे, तो इसलिए हमको इंडिविजुअली पता ही नहीं चलता, हमको कंटिन्यूटी लगती है, तो ये अराइजिंग पासिंग अवे इतनी आराम से मालूम नहीं पड़ता क्योंकि बहुत तेज़ी से हो रहा है ये। लेकिन प्रतिक्षण जो भी चित्त की करेक्टर्स, यहाँ पे से चित्त जागा, सो देयर इज अ चित्ता विच अराइजेस एंड देर आर अकम्पनिंग चेतसिक आल्सो विच अराइजेस। चेतसिक का मतलब मेंटल फैक्टर्स हैं। एक्चुअली जो संखार जिसको हम कहते हैं वो सब मेंटल फैक्टर्स ही हैं। दुर्भाग्य से उसमें सुत्ता में वेदना और संन्या को अलग कर दिया गया क्योंकि बिकॉज ऑफ देयर इंपॉर्टेंस, बट दे आर ऑल्सो मेंटल फैक्टर्स बेसिकली। तो जो बाकी है, जैसे सुत्त में हम कहते हैं विज्ञान, वेदना, संन्या, संखारा, तो वेदना, संन्या, संखारा सारे मेंटल फैक्टर्स ही हैं, तो वो सारे मेंटल फैक्टर्स के साथ होंगे, तो लोभ ग्रसित चित्त होगा या द्वेष ग्रसित चित्त होगा या मैत्री से भरा हुआ चित्त होगा या करुणा से भरा हुआ, जो भी मेंटल फैक्टर है, माइंड की क्वालिटी है, वो उस चित्त के साथ हमेशा रहेगी। चित्त के लिए कहा जाता है कि ये एक राजा की तरह, मैंने यही उदाहरण तब भी दिया था, ये एक राजा की तरह है और ये उसके मंत्री हैं, दे आर लाइक द मिनिस्टर्स। तो कोई राजा कभी अकेला नहीं जाता है, उसके साथ उसके सारे जो सपोर्टर्स होते हैं वो साथ चलते हैं। तो चित्त के साथ हमेशा कुछ ना कुछ चेतसिक जुड़े होते हैं, कुछ तो ऐसे हैं जो एथिकली न्यूट्रल हैं और कुछ हैं जिनकी एथिकली फ्लेवर है, होलसम है, अनहोलसम है। तो ये सब जागा और समाप्त हो गया। फिर जो अगला चित्त जागेगा वो इसी चित्त की संतान है एक तरह से, इट इज ए ऑफस्प्रिंग ऑफ इट, यू कैन से इट अराइजेस फ्रॉम दिस, एंड नाउ इट अराइजेस अकॉर्डिंग टू व्हाट इज कॉल्ड लॉ ऑफ कंडीशनैलिटी। नाउ दैट्स कॉम्प्लेक्स, वी कैन फॉरगेट इट दैट, बट वी व्हाट वी वांट टू अंडरस्टैंड हियर इज कि इस चित्त के जो इस समय मेरा चित्त है वो कंडीशन करेगा नेक्स्ट चित्त को, एंड वी कैन सी इट इन आवर डे टू डे लाइफ। ऐसा नहीं है कि कोई हमको मालूम नहीं पड़ता है। अगर मन में द्वेष जागता है तो वो कई क्षण तक उसका असर बना रहता है, द्वेष का गुस्सा आ रहा है, फिर मन में कुछ और भाव आएगा, फिर और भाएगा, और अगर हम उसको फ्यूल करते रहेंगे, उसमें और ऐड करते रहेंगे तो बढ़ता ही चला जाएगा, फ्यूल नहीं करेंगे। जैसे
से कहा जाता ना कि जो चित्त जागा और उसके साथ उसके चेतसिक थे, मेंटल फैक्टर्स थे बहुत सारे, वेदना थी, विज्ञान था, राग, द्वेष, जो भी, मोह या जेनरोसिटी या होलसमनेस, अच्छे चित्त संस्कार थे या होलसम थे या कुशल थे या कुशल जो भी थे, उस चित्त के बाद जो अगला चित्त जागेगा काफ़ी हाई प्रोबेबिलिटी है कि वो इसी के रंग का होगा, इसी के रंग का होगा। और अगर हम इसमें और क्या इनपुट कर रहे हैं, इसमें आग और डाल रहे हैं कि पानी डाल रहे हैं, उस पर निर्भर करेगा कि ये चित्त की चेतना कैसे बदलती चली जाएगी। तो प्रतिक्षण ये चलता रहता है, हमको इतनी रैपिडली नहीं पता चलता, लेकिन 1 सेकंड, 5 सेकंड, 10 सेकंड के इंटरवल में मालूम पड़ता रहता है, देखो इस समय द्वेष जाग रहा है और मेरे को फीलिंग बहुत अप्रिय हुई और मैंने उस पर और गुस्सा बढ़ा दिया, तो और गुस्सा बढ़ा दिया, तो मैंने चीखना चिल्लाना शुरू कर दिया। तो अगर हम जान देंगे तो देखते रहेंगे कि वो बढ़ता चला गया, बढ़ता चला गया। या जैसे उन्होंने कहा कि हम उसको देख रहे हैं, अच्छा अभी गुस्सा आ रहा है, बदन में बहुत जलन हो रही है, चलो देख लेते हैं क्या हो रहा है। तो वो जो गुस्से की जो शक्ति थी, जो उसकी एनर्जी थी, जो उसका मोमेंटम था, धीरे 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 कम होता चला गया। तो इस तरह से हमारे चित्त की चेतना प्रतिक्षण बदलती रहती है, ये होता ही रहता है, हर क्षण होता रहता है कॉन्स्टेंटली। सो यही प्रोसेस मृत्यु के समय पर भी होगी। तो दैट इज जस्ट अनदर इवेंट बिफोर एंड आफ्टर। यहाँ पे जो क्षण चित्त जैसा जागा था हमारा मृत्यु से पहले, ये चित्त अभी तक क्या हो रहा था, ये जो चित्त जागता था उसी शरीर में उत्पन्न होता था, उसी शरीर में, क्योंकि उस शरीर में एक लाइफ फोर्स थी, लाइफ फोर्स थी जो कि इसको होल्ड कर सके, चित्त को, कॉन्शियसनेस को होल्ड कर सके। अब ये लाइफ फोर्स ख़त्म हो गई, शरीर जो है क्षीण हो चुका है, उसमें इतनी लाइफ फोर्स नहीं है कि वो कॉन्शियसनेस को रोक सके अपने अंदर। तो वो जो इसमें चित्त है, जो यहाँ पे चित्त जागा है, और उसके जो चेतसिक हैं, जो भी उस समय चेतसिक जागे हैं, जो मेंटल फैक्टर जैसे कहा था ना, अंतिम चित्त में जो चेतना जागी, कैसे संस्कार जागे, कैसे थॉट्स आए, किस तरह के मैत्री के आए, कि गुस्से के आए, कि चैंटिंग की उस समय या कुछ किया, तो उसके अनुरूप, उसके अनुरूप जो भी योनि उपलब्ध होगी, उस योनि में जाके ये चित्त स्थापित हो जाएगा। तो ये कोई प्राणी नहीं है जो यहाँ से यहाँ चला गया, इट इज़ जस्ट अ नेचुरल प्रोसेस ऑफ द मूवमेंट ऑफ चित्ता फ्रॉम वन मूवमेंट टू अनदर, फ्रॉम वन मूवमेंट टू अनदर, इट गोज ऑन ड्यूरिंग अवर लाइफ एंड इट हैपन, सेम थिंग हैपन्स एट द टाइम ऑफ डेथ। सो देर इज़ नो पर्सन हु इज़ रीबॉर्न, इट इज़ जस्ट दैट द स्ट्रीम ऑफ चित्ता हैज़ अ मोमेंटम, उसमें चेतना चेतसिक में इसके अंदर एनर्जी है, वो एनर्जी क्या है, वो कम्मा है या संखार कह लीजिए उसको। तो इसलिए कहा जाता है विसंखार गतम चित्तम, चित्त में संस्कार हीन हो गए या कर्म संस्कार समाप्त हो गए, तो इसलिए कर्म संस्कार भी कहते हैं हिंदी में, कि जो कर्म संस्कार है वो समाप्त हो गए, अब कोई भी मेरा वॉल्यूशन नहीं रहा, या ऐसे समझ लीजिए सामान्य भाषा में कोई तृष्णा नहीं रही, कोई इच्छा नहीं रही किसी भी तरह की। तो अगर सामान्य जीवन में भी अगर मेरी कोई इच्छा नहीं है तो मूवमेंट नहीं होगी किसी डायरेक्शन में, तो उसी तरह से कोई इच्छा नहीं रही तो उसको आगे मूवमेंट नहीं, उसमें कोई फ्यूल ही नहीं है, उसकी सारी एनर्जी समाप्त हो गई है, ऑल द फ्यूल, एंड दैट्स व्हाई जो उपादान शब्द है इसका एक मतलब फ्यूल भी होता है, आग जो फ्यूल होता है, जैसे लकड़ी है और लकड़ी का बेसिस पे आग लगती है तो उसको उपादान कहा जाता है। तो इसे जो ग्रैस्पिंग है इट इज़ लाइक ए फ्यूल विच कीप्स अस मूव फ्रॉम वन वूम टू अनदर एंड इट लाइफ कंटिन्यूज। सो देर इज़ नो पर्सन हु इज़ बीइंग बॉर्न, इट इज़ जस्ट दैट द कम्मा इज देयर विच इज सस्टेनिंग द होल प्ले ऑफ एग्जिस्टेंस फ्रॉम वन साइकिल ऑफ अर्थ टू अनदर। दैट्स वाई वी से कम्मा योनि, जो हम चैंटिंग करते हैं दैट इज़ इट, that kamma is going to decide what will be the yoni, which birth which I will take will be the kamma which will decide where will I go. So that's the meaning of that kamma yoni we chant every time. So there is no person which is transmigrating from here to here, it's a natural phenomena which keeps on happening till such time as there is a momentum, there is an energy, there is a kamma energy in it, and it keeps on happening. So that's how we answer that question of who is reborn, who reaps the fruit of karma. There's no person who is reaping the fruit of karma. It is the chitta which has the various chetsikas in form of result of various karma, various volitional actions which you do, usme kuch chetsik hain, wo chalte rehte hain, jaate rehte hain, ek life se dusri life. So this is how we understand we answer these questions. And why we did this? Because to understand that we need to go to the root. अगर वो रूट पे नहीं जाएंगे तो समझ नहीं आएगा, वो फिर वो बिलीफ वाली बात हो जाएगी। सो वंस यू अंडरस्टैंड द रूट प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑपरेशन ऑफ माइंड, ऑपरेशन ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस और चित्ता, देन वी कैन सी हाउ इट इज हैपनिंग। हाँ जी, इसका इसका एक मिनट, इसका यार इसका वो लगा दो, ये नहीं तो सूख जाएगा यार, ये सॉरी। हाँ जी ननीश, ये लीजिए,
सर ये डायग्राम और ये एक्सप्लेनेशन तो समझ में आती है, लेकिन मैंने ये क्वेश्चन आपसे एक दफ़े पूछा था और जहाँ मैं डाउट नहीं है बट मे बी विद एन एग्जाम्पल, जैसे मैंने आपसे एक दफ़े ज़िक्र किया था
जी
कि वो मरणानुसति के ऊपर ध्यान करते हैं
जी,
तो मैंने एक वेरी सुपरफिशियल मरणानुसति करते हैं, हाँ मैं मरना मरना, उस दिन मैंने ध्यान किया, मेरे जैसे मैंने आपको डिस्क्राइब किया था
जी,
मैंने विजुलाइज किया माय द डेड बॉडी ऑफ माय फादर,
एंड ऑन द क्रिमेशन ग्राउंड वो चिता पे हैं, उनकी वो बॉडी जल रही है और मैंने वो पूरा दृश्य देखा। एक झटका तो लगा शुरू में और फिर मन बहुत शांत होने लग गया, शांत 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 शांत। सर इस पूरे डायग्राम में हुआ क्या वहाँ पे कि मेरा मन शांत क्यों हुआ वहाँ?
इट इज़ बेसिकली कि जो हमारा चेतसिक है ना, चित्त में जो मेंटल फैक्टर है फियर का, एक बहुत भारी फियर का मेंटल फैक्टर है, मृत्यु का भय सबसे ज़्यादा होता है। आपने इतने प्रिय अपने प्रिय पिता को देखा, विजुअलाइज किया उनकी डेथ को और मन बेचैन नहीं हुआ बिकॉज यू हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सेप्टेड दैट ही इज पास्ड अवे। कोई क्षोभ मन में नहीं है आपके, है ना, कोई भी उस घटना के प्रति मन में कोई ऐसा दुख नहीं है, एंग्विश नहीं है। तो जब आपने उनको देखा तो एक तरह से मन में शांत स्वभाव आ गया क्योंकि कोई भी द्वेष नहीं जागा, किसी तरह का द्वेष मतलब एवर्शन नहीं जागा, कोई भय नहीं जागा, कोई दुख नहीं जागा, कोई पिए ही विपयोगो दुखो वो अनुभूति नहीं हुई। वाई? बिकॉज यू एक्सेप्टेड हिज पास्ट अवे, हिज फादर हिज डाइड अवे। इन कंट्रास्ट आई टेल यू अबाउट माय सन्स डाइंग। इफ माय वाइफ वुड रिमेंबर, इफ यू हैव अ डिस्कशन विद इन द फैमिली ऑन द सन्स डेथ even after years, a few years, at least for first 10 years it used to happen, my wife will be totally, absolutely blown off. And I would also get affected seeing her because the memories are so, anguish was full of anguish, dying of a young child. It took us a lot of time, so many years to accept it. Oh, it's done, finished. That's a part of nature. It has happened and it's happened. So, since something is already resolved in the mind, there is no anguish, and a phenomena which is so fearsome, you are visualizing that phenomena, so it gives calmness to the mind. So the chitta has become calm because by that visualization, anguish did not arise. To some extent, the inner fear reduced, and therefore mind became calm and quiet.
That calmness, it made an effect for many more my thought process, it continued, the mind was more calmer at looking at situations, and I cannot interpret what happened.
if there is a experience of deep samadhi, it's basically experience of deep samadhi. If you can experience deep samadhi on a corpse, then that effect lasts stronger. That is a very strong effect. It basically, the calmness results from samadhi, an experience of disappearance of hindrances. Hindrances agar hat gayi, kyo us pe kaamchand to jagega nahi, vyapad jagne ki sambhavna rehti hai, hai na? Vyapad matlab anguish jaga, bechaini jagi, wo nahi jagi, hai na? Aapne jab wo visualize kiya to wo nahi jagi, aur attention pura tha, वो चीज़ ऐसी है कि उसको देखते हुए किसी को नींद आ जाए आसान नहीं है, तो वो थिन में तो नहीं जागेगा। और आपने रेस्टलेसनेस नहीं होने दी बिकॉज यू हैव एक्सेप्टेड इट, सो ऑल द फाइव हिंड्रेंसेज हैड टेम्पररीली स्टॉप्ड एंड देयरफॉर द माइंड काम्स डाउन डीपली एंड दैट इफेक्ट विल लास्ट फॉर लॉन्ग टाइम टिल सच टाइम एज समथिंग एल्स ट्रिगर्स सम अदर इफेक्ट, सम अदर फिनोमेना हैपन्स विच कॉजेज दिस, बट इफ द अदर फिनोमेना आर ऑल्सो कंड्यूसिव, you continue in that peaceful state for a long time.
There is no wisdom in this whole process.
It could be, it may not be. It depends on how you look at it. It may be. I can't say it's not. It can be. That, yeah, this is how it's going to happen to me also. This can happen to anybody. This happened to father, it can happen to anybody. Whosoever is dear to me. Now that is where the wisdom aspect will arise. So it can be wisdom, it can be not, it's not immediately evident.
So I think that's how the peace is used just seen as an end in itself. And so here we can see technically what's happened is that one mind moment has caused this peace to arise. The peace is there till the wife says something, or till something happens in the office, or till some other thought arises. And that's when the next chitta is then conditioned by that new input, and the old input of peacefulness generated by the marananusati is dying down. The wisdom, as I understand here, is now that this thing is finished, I actually then see my mind, oh, that was really a moment of peace. Let me see what happened. And that's the reflection, that's the investigation he keeps talking about. Oh, and I see, oh, so when I begin to actually see death in the right way, the mind calms down. And now let me check who is dying, etc., etc., etc. So we actually can inject, wisdom using a calm mind. But as he's saying, a calm mind in itself may or may not be a wise mind. Yeah. But that wisdom element is actually put in consciously using the things that he keeps talking about.
If you remember, for example, the same thing can happen to me. Can I see that? Can I look at it? Am I prepared to die this moment? That's another element of marananusati. So reflect, what will happen if I were to die just this moment? Is there something which I would feel bad about? Something which is left undone? What will happen to my children? What will happen to my wife? What will happen to my business? What will happen to the activities with which I am interested in? So all those attachments come to the surface. So these marananusati can be a very powerful thing if we really cultivate it in all the multiple dimensions. Then we know, oh, abhi mere man mein kahi attachment iske prati hai, iske prati hai, iske prati hai. And then we work on that. So it's a very highly recommended form of meditation. Marananusati is a very highly recommended form of meditation, both for tranquility and wisdom. But we can see the phenomena, as he nicely explained, it is just a momentary phenomena which happens. And since there is no disturbance from outside, that moment continues, that a peaceful chitta will condition another peaceful chitta, another, and you feel good about it. So it keeps on multiplying till there is an input of some kind.
So that is a state of samadhi.
Yeah, that is state of samadhi. Peace is in that sense. There can be a peace of what Ajahn Sumedho calls it, peace in amidst an inferno. He says, a rose standing in the center of an inferno, or a lotus, he uses this word, a lotus sitting in the center of an inferno. So, charon taraf aag lagi hui hai, uske jo axis hai uspe wo hai, kamal ka phool. So, wo us tarah ki, that ability comes from wisdom. You see, it's okay, it's all impermanent, going on. If the whole khandas are in turmoil, all the khandas, not just the world, the khandas are in turmoil, mind is in turmoil, sankharas are in turmoil, okay, I'm able to observe them. There is an observation of it, there is a knowing of it, you are stationed in pure awareness, and the world is going around. So that is the kind of wisdom-based deliverance, freedom, liberation, vimutti, jise kehte hai na. So that is the way we understand it. And you can get glimpses of it, you know. Sometimes, even amidst the external turmoil, you remain peaceful. Things are opening, you know. So there are those other sutta which I had quoted there, Mogaraja sutta. Isi section mein quote kiya gaya tha, Mogaraja wala jo sutta hai na. The Buddha advises him to do three things. Look at the world as empty, be ever mindful, give up the thoughts of self. And then he says, the Lord of death will not see you. That's the kind of word he asked this question, kya karun so that the Lord of death does not see me? And he replies, Mogaraja, sunnato lokam avekhanto. Look at the world as empty, there's no essence in it. Give up all thoughts of self and always be mindful. Sada sato. So that's the wisdom taking us in that direction. So then if you see the world as empty, it doesn't mean meaningless, it doesn't mean useless. It means it has no essence. It is a play. Different karma streams, there are 15 karma streams flowing around, doing everything according to their own sankharas are happening, listening, going on, interacting, and things are happening their own, fine. You are also speaking something, they are also hearing something, they are also listening something. Fine. Each of us is doing our own job.
nice. You don't take it personally in that sense.
So, sir, the sutta that you just said, the three points you said, one is always…
be mindful, ever mindful.
So, would you say mindfulness is a state of samadhi or is a state of wisdom?
State of awareness.
It's a state of awareness. So, it's a…
awareness of whatever is happening.
And not self is wisdom?
Yeah.
That would be the wisdom area.
Yeah.
And the mindfulness would be…
the tool.
Mindfulness the tool,
is
so
the
that
gate to deathlessness.
Right.
Is the tool.
So, wo vinyan, yeah, the consciousness, yeah, vinyan. No, I mean, not consciousness, the five khandas.
It is a mental factor.
Yes.
Sati is a mental factor.
It's the combination of all the five khandas.
Being seeing, that is, sati is one of the mental factors which accompanies consciousness when the chitta is wholesome. Though, of course, other traditions say it is always there, but Theravada tradition believes that when the chitta is wholesome, then mindfulness is present. So, you can be aware, what's going on, what's going on. I'm, there's a pain going on in the body, sound is coming, I mean, the hearing is going on, listening is going on, seeing is going on, tasting is going on, anger is arising, joy is arising. So, we are aware of whatever is happening. And then you couple it with the wisdom, with panya. So, that panya is to be coupled with it. Panya means two dimensions. The Attanuditti, he uses those words. The wrong view of Atta and Sunyatoyam Loke. The whole world is empty, it has no essence. Just as not only you have no essence, the world also has no essence in that sense. It's just a play of phenomena of karma. What they say, no, ownerless. This is what I had, I think, written, if I remember correctly. It's ownerless karma flowing along. So, says ownerless karma is rolling along. Don't take it personally. It's okay. So, that's the kind of brief encapsulation of that dimension.
Thank you. Sorry to have taken you
good, off. Good, good, good. Very good.
The time duration, 10 to the power minus 7.
I have written, yeah. People say minus 9, minus okay. 10. I don't know.
It's not been measured or
no.
It's not standard.
No, no, there's no standard. People say millions, somebody says billions, I don't know. There's only reference to, in one Abhidhamma, I had seen a reference to Sariputta's abilities that he could see 15 mind moments. It's phenomenal. I mean, at one time he could see 15 mind moments,
yeah.
Which means 15 into billionth second. And for us it is, even if we can see few seconds, that's a big job.
Thich Nhat Hanh says that this every moment is about 0.0169 seconds.
Maybe.
Those figures are…
The Theravada Abhidhamma talks of millionth of a second. So, we don't know. Because it's beyond our reach really. We only can get an average of phenomena. We get an averaging effect of few seconds if we are really mindful. Otherwise, it can be minutes.
But I think that's a more importantly, setting aside the mathematics of it,
yeah.
We can actually see it happen just as we sit. Yeah, I mean, I've been wanting like coffee for the last like 30 minutes. I can see like every few seconds it comes back up, and feeling that it's becoming really cold now. And you know,
when will he stop?
Yeah, why is this guy going on? You know, I really want coffee now. You know, so you can actually see it happen as we speak. We don't really need mathematics for it. And we can actually see these things. You know, you can actually, even as we say, we don't need to have our eyes closed or. You can actually see it all the time. That's the sati he's talking
yeah,
about.
Yeah, we can be aware. In fact, it is easier to be aware with open eyes. I mean, that's my current understanding level. It's more easy to be aware with, because hum log addict ho gaye hain aankh band karke baithne ke. And I have become, seven decades of habit.
Meditation actually is
a
hindrance in this
in that sense.
In developing sati, because you can actually see it much better right now.
My question is, when the mind is not mindful, and let's say he's gone into thoughts, or he's gone into thinking, so it's like daydreaming. I mean, no, it's not daydreaming, he's in thought, but there is no awareness, mindfulness. So where is that state? What would that state be defined as? Or the when he's in deep sleep, he's not even in deep sleep, but he can see his dreams also while he's sleeping.
And the dream state is also falls within this very domain. Chitta rising, passing away.
Right.
Deep sleep is a different
ball game. No, that is gone.
That's a different ball game. There's a bhavanga chitta operating, so that's a more complex thing. We can ignore it.
No, that ignore. But when you are
dreaming,
you can see your dreams, you are conscious of the dreams going on. And
Because it's all mind created stuff, actually.
Mm.
And Buddha tells us, actually, the whole world which we see, even in waking state, is a mind created stuff.
Yeah.
There's very little difference between dream state and the. Only thing is, in the waking state there is the coherence. In the dream state there is no coherence because it is entirely mind created. In even now when I sit and see you, it all is my mind's creation. I don't see you as you are, or we don't see things as they are. We see as they are perceived by our faculties. Yeah.
My perception of your perception and my.
It's too complex, really.
I have a question.
Question? Okay, now we are at the end of this, so we can have one or two questions. So next time we'll discuss second noble truth. So you covered first.
My question is related to this kamma and transfer of energy. I understand when it is passed within the same body, from mind to mind to mind to mind. Because for me, from where I stand right now, my chitta is also related to my body. But when the energy dies of this body and chitta finds a new body, I do not understand how, because it has to be the same chitta, the chitta will go to.
It is not same. It's not different. Neither it is different nor is it same. Because even during day to day, I mean at this moment as I talk, the chitta is arising, passing away, they are not exactly same.
They're but why?
Conditioned, they are getting conditioned
by. Insignia to why carry
inputs, charon taraf se input aa rahi hai na. There are inputs of this, I heard him say something, he's like, I will ban chuk kyun nahi kar raha, so that will have an effect on my chitta, isn't it? And things of that kind. So they're so subtly happening, multiple influences happening. So the prominent characteristic remains the same.
But when it's a fetus, it has no chitta. I mean, it has.
When it has?
A fetus, a new body, has nothing.
Yeah,
no,
so that's
no
why it is said consciousness is.
So consciousness transfer ke, it similar wo to hai nahi, wo to bina chit ke hai, it has no volition, nothing.
No,
it's just a mass of flesh.
It has a nama. It has nama and rupa. It's not just mass of flesh. It's not the fetus is not just mass of flesh.
Jab transfer ho gayi,
then conscious sankhara pachya vinyanam, when vinyana pachya naam rupam. So vinyana is conditioned that, you know, we had studied that many a times. You remember that sutta we had studied? Of course, he had used the conventional language. If consciousness descends into a womb and the womb is not ready, will the consciousness hold? He said, no. Consciousness is not hold.
So,
the fetus has to be ready to receive it.
So fetus ka consciousness aur iska jo chit, dono chit match nahi hona hota. I thought
wo consciousness hai, usme naam hai. Naam is the ability to feel. The ability to feel. You know?
Okay.
That way. So it's not just a dead piece of matter. It's not like lump of flesh, meat lying on the ground. Fetus is not like that. It has certain capabilities.
But also one can get caught in this. So I don't know if that really helps in the answer. It's one of those questions that perhaps if one doesn't understand, it doesn't impact.
Yeah, that's true. There is, we had studied that sutta, you know, where he mentions about it. What was it called? Tanha. Mahatanha Sankhaya Sutta or something. We can have a look at it and then discuss it. It's not
of great importance really for this purpose.
Sir, first novel truth से अलग थोड़ा सा पूछना चाहता था.
नहीं, इसी से पूछिए.
अच्छा, इसी से.
इसी से पूछिए और कुछ नहीं पूछिए. Because we are focused on just trying to understand this and make sure that we understand it to the best possible extent. ताकि मुझे भी समझ में आ जाए. Please do it next.
अच्छा, जैसे हमने कहा कि ये चित्त जो है, जब एनर्जी डेड हो गई.
डेड नहीं होती एनर्जी.
एनर्जी नहीं, लास्ट में जब
the body is no longer.
Body is no longer
able to hold the chitta.
तो वो अब चित्त दूसरी बॉडी में जाएगा. अब ये मैं जानना चाह रहा था कि for information sake.
This is a way of saying it actually.
हाँ, but point ये है कि
way of saying the chitt उसरे चित्त में जाएगा. ऐसा होता नहीं है, because it's just a plenum. There's no being existing here. It's a matter of ये कहने में आता है. जैसे बुद्धा also says this consciousness descends into the womb. It's a concession given to language. Just for the sake of understanding.
But when we talk rebirth, जैसे हम बात करते हैं.
जी जी.
अब rebirth में तो यही है ना कि that somebody the same chitta is getting reborn.
It's not same. The the next chitta which arises from the last chitta that finds a place, so to say, to go somewhere. It's just a matter.
I'm talking about the chitta which is there when the
person is about
energy chitta. Energy of the body has just finished. Now ceased. Yeah. The chitta which is at that time which has arisen, that will now go to
another,
the next
another body.
Another
find
body.
Another body.
That's right. तो कहने का मतलब ये था कि अगर ये जो हमारी आबादी है जिस हिसाब से बढ़ रही है, what we were in 40s and what are we today, तो वो जो चित्त है वो मतलब ये तो normally speaking तो उतना ही रहने चाहिए थे.
See, these are questions which are achinteyo. Achinteyo means unthinkable.
Unthinkable.
Because we have a perception that all that exists in the universe is on the planet Earth.
Hmm.
Which is wrong.
Oh, we are saying that Devlok and others.
Yeah, yeah. There are, obviously there are so many things.
Hmm. Okay.
There are some questions, you know, which he said are achintayo. They should not. They are not thinkable. Like for example, kama vipaka achintayo. अब ये कुछ कर्म का फल अब आया है. Just can't figure it out. You have to just speculate and.
There's also the cost of being disrespectful. Actually, it doesn't really tie up with what we're talking about. So intellectually, it's really interesting, and maybe we can speak with him one to one because there are others who might be on a different wavelength.
It
might be healthier to stick to.
Use this opportunity to understand these basic concepts as deeply, as clearly as possible.
Sir, can you explain that concept of what is Dhamma theory with related to quark? I mean,
no, forget it.
Okay, that's number 3. If you look at recording number 3, it's all there.
Okay. Now, in the one of the thing which you said that there is a story where you're saying, you just mentioned that I can be watching and a thief can come and take things. What is it? Is it anecdotal or?
Yeah, it is only a story given by Ajahn Brahma. Brahma from Australia.
Okay.
He recites this story to explain that mindfulness is something more than that. Just observing what is going and what is coming, that's all. There is some wisdom element is also there, because along with mindfulness there is samma vayamo. We had discussed it, because it's not a question here, that's why I'm not mentioning it, but it's important. No? Samma vayamo means what comes in. Wholesome things we allow to come in, unwholesome we don't allow to come in. That also is a part of our practice. So that's what he meant. No? Samavayama, that you allow only the wholesome habits to come in and strengthen the wholesome habits. Unwholesome habits from outside should not enter into us. And whatever unwholesome habits we have, we discard them, slowly remove them. So that also is a part of the process. You know? All the eight folds of the path should be strengthened, harmoniously integrated. Any other?
Sir, initially, in the Noble Truth, it says that there is dukkha. There are three aspects to it. Are we going to discuss that, sir?
Which aspects?
That there is there is dukkha, it is to be understood, it has been understood.
We'll come to that later.
Later.
We'll come to that later. We'll come to that in the practice part of it, yeah. Yeah. We had it in the discussion. So we're trying to go as much as possible in the sequence in which we discussed it. So first noble truth we have been able to discuss today. So if there's any other issue pertaining to that, Panchupadan, Khanda, concept of Anatta, we can spend a few more minutes. It's already 6:10, so maybe 5 more minutes and then stop.
First, you're mindful. Then it's not self.
Then?
It's not self. It's not me. It's the selfless, the non-self concept.
Please go ahead.
Anatta. And then, like, then what?
The issue is that the statement that there is not, this is not self, is just a statement, isn't it? Just a word, few words. Do we really understand it deeply? Do we really, what is not self? Rupa, Vedana, Sanya, Sankhara. So we have to see each one of those Sankharas, Sanya, and understand. It's a path of understanding, isn't it? It's a question of understanding, and once we understand, that should reflect in our day-to-day behavior, that should reflect in our response to external situations. So all that needs practice, isn't it? So the key thing is to be mindful and see, we'll come to that in when we talk about second noble truth, you know, how the suffering arises and all that. First was only there is suffering, we only discussed that. So in second noble truth, we'll see what is the cause of suffering and then we'll be able to go in that direction. Okay?
Are you really aware of the movement of the chitta? And if so, if it goes from one body to other, what is the periodicity?
What is the
periodicity? What is the time it takes? At what time it enters?
It doesn't really matter, no? There are different people, different traditions have different answers.
My question is,
in Theravada tradition, they believe instantaneously. In other traditions, they believe it takes time. So how does it matter?
Hence, there is no fixed time.
You see, we can't predict, no? This question is something which we can't answer, isn't it? All I can say is, in the Sutta, the Buddha has not mentioned it. Okay, that's all I can say. And from the inference, it comes from the teachings, it is instantaneous. Because chitta arises, passes away, it has to happen instantaneously without break.
In
Theravada tradition, this is the understanding.
You have to believe it. It goes to another body, but at what stage it is not ready?
At what stage?
What stage?
I don't know.
The moment conception occurs, simply chemical reaction is there. At what moment?
I don't know really. Neither has Buddha answered this question, so I know only that much what I have read. I'm sure Buddha knew much more than that. But whatever I have read, I am answering on that basis. There is no mention of time anywhere. Okay, so we can...
practice that we should do for the first...
Yeah, I mean, presently we should really reflect on all that we have done today. And prepare for the understanding of second noble truth. So that next time when we meet, we discuss the second, third, fourth in that sense, isn't it? First was, there is suffering. And we know what we had discussed earlier, it should be understood. We are trying to understand it. You know? And we are also to understand it in practice when it happens. So we already discussed that issue there in the practice. So I can briefly repeat it again. What is to be done? When we are experiencing suffering, we sit and try to experience what is going on and allow the natural wisdom, which will happen only if you have understood first noble truth. If you have not understood it, there will be no wisdom, it will not arise. If you have a basic theoretical background which is clear, not just of first, but also of second and third noble truths, then you will be able to penetrate. So when we say suffering should be understood, they all go hand in hand. First noble truth, second noble truth, they are just intertwined. Understanding of first noble truth should lead to understanding of second noble truth. So therefore, the practice should be done when we have really done all the four. Then, or at least first two. That's why if you remember, we studied two, and then we shifted, then we studied others. So let's study the two. But you all know, we already discussed what is to be practiced. For the next week, I would suggest, please deeply reflect on what we have done today. If you have some questions, then you ask that. I'll be really happy to try to answer them. But also reflect on second noble truth, because that is the, what is the cause? And see it in the light of dependent origination. You remember that? We had studied it. We had not only studied the cause in the terms of Krishna and all that, we had also studied the mechanics of that. So all that should be included in the second noble truth. So then we'll become more clear. And once we have studied one, two, then really the practice can be done very systematically. Okay?
So there's one thing I have felt, okay, sometimes that even when I'm aware of a defilement, I'm observing the defilement, it increases, it doesn't cease. This thing has happened with me. It's weird.
So you should reflect back. If you remember that event, sit down quietly, have a cup of tea and recreate that event and see what happened.
So I did
something
that.
Something must have happened, really.
So I did that. I realized that whenever I'm going to the cause, it is suddenly like giving. It's like something like giving the fuel to the defilement, or again. But it has to come down.
If the cause is something which you like very much, that is what happens.
That's it.
If the cause is something to which you have very strong attachment.
Right.
It can be very,
but
very,
then
it can create a problem.
Awareness not stronger than the thought of cause? Like, right. What's
it's wisdom is not there. No? Wisdom has to be there to be able to see. Right. If there's a very strong attachment and you realize the cause of suffering is attachment, but the attachment is so strong that you don't want to give it up, then you'll cry. I have seen people cry. Don't tell me to investigate. Stop. I don't want to do this. Why? You say you give up attachment to sun. How can it be possible? Forget it. If I think about that, giving up attachment to sun, it makes me more suffer. That's it. So if the cause is of a kind which we love so much, and that is the cause of suffering, we discover that is the cause of suffering, then it's a real challenge to give it up, to let go of that. Because that's where the cutting will take place. So it will take time. So do it again. Someday it will break through.
So another thing, when I'm observing, when I'm being mindful, there are different things going on. Like I'm mindful about the mental state. Okay. Right now I'm angry. Suddenly my attention goes to my breathing. Then sometimes it will again go to some kind of sensation, like warm feeling around my cheeks, in my cheeks or in my body. I mean, there are many things. And then I again think about anicca. So, am I losing my focus? Like, why am I thinking about so many things?
Why do you want focus? Why do you love focus so much? What is happening is fine, very good.
Okay.
We should give up that idea of focus, na?
Right.
Don't bother. And don't think about anicca, please. Don't think about it. It's actually there. Just see it. So you don't have to think about it. And forget about the focus and mind running away and wandering away. That's fine. If you are aware of the wandering away of the mind, you are mindful. That's it. If you are aware that the mind is wandering away, you are there. At that moment, you are mindful. Finished. Isn't it? If you become aware that mind is wandering away, you are mindful at that time. That's it. So your practice is going on. There's no interruption in practice. So we should give up those old notions of mind should be within my control and it should remain, it should not think, it should not go here and there. That's okay, that's okay. That has its own value, but this is not investigation. That doesn't have value in Vipassana. That has value in concentration, samadhi, not awareness. Fine. So let's do the closing homage and little bit of metta chant. So we'll do some simple metta chant. Bhavatu sabba mangalam, rakkantu sabba devata, sabba buddhanu bhavena, sadasauti bhavantu me. Bhavatu sabba mangalam, rakkantu sabba devata, sabba dhammanu bhavena, sadasauti bhavantu te. Bhavatu sabba mangalam, rakkantu sabba devata, sabba sanghanu bhavena, sada sotti bhavantu te. Arhan samma sambuddho bhagava, buddhan bhagavantan abhivadi. Sakkato bhagavata dhammo dhammam namassami. Supatipanno bhagavato savaka sangho sangham namami. Pay respects to the shrine.